Special thank you to our Mustang media team for filming the event. And now for our 2024 basketball homecoming court. Our first representatives from the freshman class are Kinley Dowdy and Nolan Goode. Kinley is the daughter of Susan Ostrom and Luke Dowdy. Nolan is the son of the late Matt Goode and Casey Wallace. Our next ninth grade representatives are Nyla Holder and Brennan Hartman. Nyla is the daughter of Holly and Gary Holder. Brennan is the son of Crystal and Michael Hartman. Our Our third freshman representatives are Natalie Jones and Jay Martin. Natalie is the daughter of Jay Montegadue and Keith Jones. Jay is the son of Lily Rivera and Anderson Martin. Our last freshman representatives are Kevin Riley and Trent Webb. Bailey is the daughter of Tasha and Kyle Riley. Trent is the son of Amy and Josh Webb. Representing the sophomore class are Abby Allred and Mason Clark. Abby is the daughter of Summer Powers and Kevin Allred. Mason is the son of Ryan and Melissa Clark. Our next 10th grade representatives for MCHS are Aethlyn Nichols and Ty Pena. This is the daughter of Brittany Nichols and Luke Nichols. Ty is the son of JoJo and John Pina. Our third sophomore representatives are Madeline Shelby and Nicole Fisher. Madeline is the daughter of Tracy Shelby and the late Mark Shelby. Nicole is the son of May Fisher and Tariq Sayed. Representing the junior class are Emily Knight and Jay Springboy. Representatives for this evening are Izzy Shear and Preston Harper. Izzy is the daughter of Stacy and Chris Shear. Preston is the son of Justin Harper and Jill Harper Hobbs. And now let's meet our senior class homecoming candidates. Representing the class of 2024, are Amy Ebby Corsi and Cohen Hook. Yeah. Ebby is the daughter of Mandy and David Huck and the late Jim Corsi. Ebby is a member of the McCracken County dance team, captain of the Mustangs, and has earned KHSAA Academic All-State First Team for 3 years. Ebby is a student and teaching assistant at Main Stage Performing Arts Center and Theater and member of the National Honor Society. Ebby was our NBA All-American team member for 2023-24. She is a recipient of the Daughters of the American Revolution Youth Citizenship Award in 2023 and a Paducah Rotary Club Student of the Month for December 23. Ebby is an active member at Fountain Avenue United Methodist Church. Ebby plans to major in interior design in either the University of Kentucky or Auburn University. Cohen is the son of Mindy and Ryan Hood. Cohen is a member of HOSA and the McCracken County track team. Our next senior class candidates are Anna Kate Hawes and Cameron McDowell. Anna Kate is the daughter of Robin and Chad Hawes. Anna Kate is a 4-year member of the McCracken County softball team and McCracken County cross country team. Anna Kate is a member of the National Honor Society and Beta Club. Anna Kate was also selected as a Paducah Bank Teen Ambassador. Anna Kate, member of the Lubbock Church of Christ. Anna Kate plans on attending Murray State University and majoring in biology. Cameron is the son of Renee and Eric McDowell. Cameron is a member of the National Honor Society, Fellowship of Christian Athletes, FCCLA, National Society of High School Scholars, and the current president of Beta Club, and future business leaders of America, as well as being treasurer of HOSA. Cameron is a Paducah Bank Team Ambassador, Murray State Team of the Week recipient, and Jackson purchased Electric Cooperative Voter Co-op Ambassador, where he was a representative from the state of Kentucky in NRCA's 2023 Electric Cooperative Youth Tour at Frankfort, Kentucky and Washington, D.C. Cameron is an AP scholar and on track to be a valedictorian. He is also an active member of Heartland Church and plans to major in business and finance at Western Kentucky University in the fall. Our next two candidates are Kyla Hawkins and Cannon Ford. Kyla is the daughter of Shelly and Jason Hawkins. Kyla is an active member in FCCLA, FCA, and MHS. She is a contestant in The Voice McCracken and is involved in many music activities outside of the school. Kyla performs at festivals and venues around Western Kentucky and Clarksville. She has plans on attending Belmont University and majoring in songwriting. Cannon is the son of Stacy Adam Ford. Cannon is a member of the MCHS golf team, track team, and cross country team. He has made it to the state championship in golf, track, and baseball. Cannon participates in FCA, FCCLA, and attends Sutton Lane Church of Christ. Cannon will graduate as an honors grad and will be attending Florida College to play golf and will be majoring in business and finance. Next we have Isabel Miller and Xander Smith. Isabella is the daughter of Jennifer and Ray Miller. Isabella was captain of the varsity volleyball team and played volleyball for 4 years. She is an FCA leader, FCCLA vice president of public relations, Every Mustang Matters leader, member of Beta Club, National Honor Society, Student Government, and Rotary Club. Isabella is an honors graduate and attends Heartland Church and Young Life. Isabella plans to attend the University of Kentucky in the fall. Xander is the son of Michelle and Corey Smith. Xander has played baseball and basketball all 4 years of high school. He suffered a season-ending injury, but is determined to return to baseball at the end of the year. Xander is currently a part of FCA and FBLA. He plans on playing baseball in college. Xander is still undecided on which college he plans on attending, but plans on becoming an athletic trainer. Xander attends Salton Lake Community Church. Cameron is the daughter of Sherry and J.D. Hale and the late Fred White. Cameron has been a member of the MCHS All-Girl Cheerleading Team for the past 4 years, where she received the Rookie of the Year Award, Freshman Year Most Valuable Cheerleader Award her junior year, and was selected as a UCA All-American Cheerleader senior year. Cameron also received the Academic All-State Award for the past 3 years. Cameron is involved in the National Honor Society, Fellowship of Christian Athletes, and HOSA. She is also a MCHS peer tutor. Cameron is an active member of Spring Bible Baptist Church and coached upward cheerleading for 3 years. Connor is the son of Eileen and Tino Miller. Connor has been a member of the McCracken County Varsity Team for 4 years. He is also a recipient of First Team Academic All-State for 4 years. Connor is a member of FCA and the National Honor Society. Our former King and Queen Caroline Smith and Nolan Toller are unable to be with us today. In their place, Senior SBA President Thomas Palace and Hattie Dover Senior SBA Vice President will be crowning our new king and queen. And now, for the crowning of the homecoming king and queen of McCracken County High School, as voted on by the entire student body of MCHS, our 2024 basketball homecoming king and queen are Isabella Miller and Cameron McDowell.
Then from the free throw line down at St. Mary's, the Lady Mustangs shot 91.7% from the free throw line, almost 92%. So some excellent shooting outside the arc, a little bit down for the Lady Mustangs. They were 30.8% outside the arc, but overall there wasn't a lot of need for the Lady Mustangs to be shooting outside the arc, and we'll talk about that right now. We'll talk about that in the scoring when you look at the leading scorers for the Lady Mustangs. First of all, Claire Johnson led the way. She had 21 points. Lazaria Boland was number two on the team. She had an excellent game coming in there. She started because Jaden Skaggs was out. She had a great night. She ended up with 17 points. Mickey Buchanan ended up with 12. And Ava Hughes ended up with 10. I think, Eric, so far this season, that could be the first game that we had four Lady Mustangs in double digits from a scoring standpoint. And then the scoring just continued. I want to go down through the rest of the group and give them some attention. Ella Shelburne, who come off the bench, she had six. She hit two nice three-pointers. Ariana Bryson, she had a good game. She had five. Reagan Hill had four. Janae Reed had another good game. Two games in a row for Janae Reed. She's been on the scoring card. She ended up with 4 points. Megan Swinford ended up with two. Abby Casebeer had two. Brooklyn Preston had two. So you had a lot of Lady Mustangs that scored the other night down there in that ball game. And I think there's a couple things there to give credit to. You know, the first group really didn't play, but maybe two and a half quarters overall. The rest of that was by the second and third group, and they did an excellent job continuing the scoring for the Lady Mustangs. Taking a little bit of a look as far as from the field, Eric, this is a statistic that you don't see too often. And I never noticed this when you and I finished up the game on Tuesday night, but Lazaria Boland, who we just talked about, had 17 points. She was 8 for 8 from the floor. She shot 100%. So anytime you take 8 shots and you're 100%, you're having a great night. So Lazaria Boland had a great evening. Abby K. Spears, she only took one shot. She shot at 100%. Claire Johnson, she was at 77%. Mickey Buchanan was at 71. Ella Shelbourne, who I just mentioned, she was at 66. She was 2 for 2 outside the arc. Ariana Bryson, she was 2 for 3 as well. She was at 66%. Reagan Hill, she had a good night as well shooting. Reagan Hill was 1 for 2. She was at 50%. And then you just continue down that list, and all the Lady Mustangs who did take shots during that game, except for a couple, were better than 50%. So overall, excellent shooting by the Lady Mustangs down there at St. Mary's. Talk a little bit about the three-point field goals outside the arc there. Overall, one of the Lady Mustangs who did have a really good evening shooting was Ella Shelbourne. I talked about her coming off the bench. She took two opportunities outside the arc, hit them both, so she shot 100%. The other one, Lazaria Bowl, and she was 1 for 1. We just mentioned that. She shot 100%. And then Ariana Bryson took a three-pointer as well. She hit it, so she was at 100%. So when you look at that, you have three Lady Mustangs who shot 100% outside the arc. The rest of the Lady Mustangs didn't hit any. The rest of them were a little colder the other night at St. Mary's. Mickey missed a few. Claire missed a few. So overall, we had a couple Lady Mustangs really hot outside the arc. Couple of them. The rest of the gang was a little bit cold outside the arc.
That's right.
Taking a look at the free throws. The free throws was the other area I mentioned. The Lady Mustangs did a great job. Took 12 total attempts from the free throw line. Hit 11 of those. So right at 92%. Janae Reed was 2 for 2. Claire was 1 for 1. Reagan Hill, she was 2 for 2. And then you drop down a little bit. Mickey Buchanan was 2 for 2. Ava Hughes missed the sole free throw for the night, but she was 4 for 5. So, you know, you had four Lady Mustangs hit 100% from the free throw line, and Ava Hughes at 80%. I can tell you right now, Eric, Coach Sivils will take that every single night, that kind of percentage from the free throw line. Looking at it from a rebounding standpoint, Reagan Hill led the way. Reagan had 7 rebounds in that game. She had an excellent game. Second leading rebounder in that game was Mickey Buchanan. She had 5. Third leading rebounder was Abby Kayspear, who came in and played there in the third and fourth quarter. She ended up with 3 rebounds. And then you had about 6 or 7 other Lady Mustangs that they also had rebounds in that game. So when you look at it, Eric, statistically, the Mustangs had a great evening. And the biggest part of that, where do we want to give credit? First of all, we got to give credit to the defense. And that defense created a ton of turnovers in that game at St. Mary's. And those turnovers led to fast break points. And as you and I called that game on Tuesday night, we know that Claire made a number of layups, and so did Lazaria Bowl, and that's really what contributed to that high shooting percentage, particularly for Lazaria Bowl, and is putting up layups. And those young Lady Mustangs, they didn't miss any layups at all. I think at one point there was a comment you or I made that I think Ava Hughes missed one, and that may have been the only layup that the Lady Mustangs missed in the first half of that game. So an excellent game overall performance wise. I think another thing, Eric, that you and I talked about Tuesday night, I just want to continue to talk a little bit about, was the play of that second and third group. You know, that was one of the things going into that game. We watched that second and third group play a little bit down at Tillman, and at times they struggled a little bit down at Tillman, but their execution against St. Mary's was excellent on Tuesday night. They did a good job offensively passing the ball around the perimeter, finding open shooters. They just did a really good job overall.
Indeed. It was overall just a wonderful performance altogether to get that win. And then the second game, quite the game.
Yeah, Eric, that was an exciting one to call. That was one of probably the more exciting ones that you and I have called all season long. I mean, when you look at that game, taking a look at the boys' game there right after that on the second game on Tuesday night, you know, overall, the Mustangs got off to a little slow start. We got to give credit to St. Mary's. They did a good job shooting the ball, particularly outside the arc. They were able to get a lead on the Mustangs going into halftime. If I remember correctly, I think they were up about 4 there at halftime. And then overall, we got into that second half and really wanted the Mustangs to come out and do a really good job getting back in that game, because they hadn't been in the game much in that first and second quarter. But I think the situation that occurred was, you know, St. Mary's came out, they really punched. They threw the first punch in that third quarter, and overall they were able to increase that lead to 7, and ultimately about midway through that third quarter they were able to get the lead up to double digits. They hit that 10-point lead, and it looked like for a moment the Mustangs were in a little bit of trouble. But, You know, Coach Roberts called a timeout there. He regrouped his team. They came out of it, and there was some excellent scoring there. There was a point there about a period of 90 seconds, maybe 2 minutes overall, that the Mustangs scored 9 consecutive points and cut the lead to 1 point. We got to give Connor Miller a lot of credit. He came out of that timeout. He put up a quick 4 points. Owen Grogan was on the floor as well. He put up some quick points. As a matter of fact, I think he put up 7 just in that third quarter alone. He had a great quarter, and that helped cut that lead. And then the Mustangs were able to grab a 1 point lead going into that fourth quarter. And they just continued to stay ahead somewhere between 3, 5, or 7 points throughout that fourth quarter, and ended up winning that game 59-53. So it was a 6-point win overall. But I think one of the things is we've got to highlight is there was 18 seconds left in that game, and the Mustangs were only up 2. And they had possession of the ball. They fouled Jackson Clope. Jackson went to the free throw line, 2 critical free throws in that game. He sunk them both, got up 4 points, went back down, played good defense. St. Mary's missed a shot. Caden Fulcher come down with the rebound. They fouled him immediately. He went down, and he made both of his free throws. So 4 free throws in a row there by the Mustangs overall, shooting 100% in that last 18 seconds of the game. So they did a really, really good job to pull out that 6-point victory. Like I said, with 18 seconds to go, they were only up 2 points. The free throw shooting carried them. So let's take a little look at the stats in that game for that 6-point win for the Mustangs. They only shot 50% from the field, so not a good night overall from the field for the Mustangs, and only shot 27% outside the arc. So when you look at that, that was part of the difference in that game was St. Mary's did a great job shooting outside the arc. The Mustangs were struggling overall, but where the Mustangs made it up, as I just said, really was at the free throw line. The Mustangs shot 85% from the free throw line. They had a great night. So dropping down and looking, who was doing the scoring for the Mustangs? First of all, Connor Miller, he had a big game. He had 16 points overall. But like I said, I think it was those critical points that he scored in the third quarter to get the Mustangs back in that game when they were down double digits that made the difference. Jackson Clope, he had 10. Now, one thing we got to mention, Eric, is Jackson Clope spent some time on the bench. He got in foul trouble down there in St. Mary's. We're going to talk a little bit about that in the pregame tonight against Graves County. Jackson had a little bit of foul trouble down there, so he spent a good bit of time on the bench. He only had 10 points overall in the game. And then Dylan Jackson, he had another good game, another double-digit night. Dylan Jackson had a total of 10. Here's a guy I want to talk a little bit about is Owen Grogan. He came on the floor, took Jackson Clope's position, which is, as I say, some big shoes to fill for Owen Grogan. But he did an excellent job. Like I said, he had 7 points. I think he scored all those in the third quarter. And really, him and Connor Miller combined together to really cut that 10-point lead down to 1. So Owen Grogan did an excellent job there midway through the third quarter. Jackson Diaz, he had a total of 5 points, and I've got to give him credit as well. Jackson Diaz had a good game. He came off the bench. He was in there filling in as well some for Jackson Clope. He did an excellent job. He had a total of 5 points. Caden Fulcher, he came off the bench. He had 5 points. 2 of those last 2 free throws in the last 7 seconds of the game that really sealed it for the Mustangs to get that victory. And then Jay Martin, or Grayson Parrish, he had a total of 4. And Jay Martin had another kind of quiet evening. He only had 2 points overall. When you look at the shooting from the floor, Jackson Clope continues to be consistent from the floor. He was 4-for-6. He shot 66%. Just as I mentioned, Jackson Diaz, he had a good night. He was 2-for-3. He shot at 66%. Connor Miller, he was 5-for-8. He shot at 62%. Owen Grogan, who I just mentioned, he was 3-for-5. He shot at 60%. So overall, you had 1, 2, 3, 4. You had 4 Mustangs shoot better than 60% from the floor. And then from the three-point range, like I said, the Mustangs overall struggled a little bit outside the arc. When we look outside the arc overall at that game, Caden Fulcher had the best evening. He was 1-for-2. He shot 50%. Dylan Jackson, he was 3-for-8. So he shot 37.5. Good night for Dylan Jackson. Owen Grogan, he made a 3-pointer as well in that 7-point effort. He shot at 33%, and then Connor Miller was shooting at 33%. He was 1-for-3 as well. We had a few other Mustangs take some 3-pointers outside the arc, missed those. So overall, as a team, the Mustangs were 6-for-22 outside the arc, only shooting 27%, so a little bit of a low night for the Mustangs. Taking a look at the free throws, nearly identical to what we just saw in the Lady Mustangs. The Lady Mustangs were 11-for-12. The boys in the very next game, they were 11-for-13. Caden Fulcher, as I said, he hit 2 key going down the stretch, he shot 100%. Jackson Diaz, he was 1-for-1. He hit that 100% mark. Jackson Clope, as I mentioned, he hit really the two key free throws to get that four-point lead with 18 seconds. He shot 100%. And then when you look at a couple other guys there shooting free throws, Connor Miller was 5-of-6. He's up there north of 80%, which he's been really throughout the season, starting about the early January. And then Dylan Jackson was 1-for-2. He shot 50. So when you look at it, they did a great job shooting the ball from the free throw line. That was a big difference in that second half. Taking a little look at the rebounds, the Mustangs were a little down on the rebounding side of it. They only had 26 total rebounds overall. I think they're averaging about almost 30 for the season per game. When we look at it overall, Jackson Clope led the way. He had 7 total rebounds. One of the things I've got to say, it's one of the few times that we've won a game that Jackson Clope has been below double digits on rebounds. But I think the big thing that contributed to that on Tuesday night was he spent so much time on the bench. He was just in foul trouble really early on in the game and sat on the bench a good bit. But one of the guys that stepped up, and this is a number, Eric, I think is key to look at tonight, is Grayson Parrish. He had 6 total rebounds. So he stepped up there and filled a little bit of that gap while Jackson Clope was on the bench. The other guy that had a good game rebounding-wise, Connor Miller, he had 3. Dylan Jackson, he had 3. Like I said, Jackson Diaz came off the bench. He had 3 as well. And then we had a few other Mustangs pick up 1 apiece. So overall, it was pretty balanced rebounding, but I got to give a lot of credit to Grayson Parrish. He stepped up when he needed to when Jackson Clope was on the bench.
That's exactly right. And the Mustangs were able to get the win on the road. It's never easy to win at St. Mary, but the Mustangs were able to do it as McCracken County got the 59-53 win on Tuesday night. It's a raucous atmosphere here at Strawberry Hills Pharmacy Arena. Always fun when the band is in the house as McCracken County and Graves County getting set to square off. Let's go ahead and look at these two teams for tonight. And once again with that, as he breaks down the matchup before us, it is Jimmy Garrett.
So let's take a little bit of a look at it, Eric. Let's look at Graves County overall so far this season. When we take a look at it here tonight, you know, overall, I see two players there. When I take a look at them team-wise, I think one of the first things, Eric, I want to talk about is this is the second team that we saw. One of the things we talked about in that St. Mary's game is they had a little bit of difficulty scoring points overall. And when you look at the Graves County Lady Eagles, not a whole lot better. They're at 48 points a game versus 38 that the Lady Vikings were at. But when you look at their shooting percentage, it's fairly low for a team. When I look at it, Eric, from the field right now, the Lady Eagles, they're shooting 35.2% from the field and only 29% outside the arc. The only area that they seem to be shooting pretty well from the free throw line right now, they're averaging 73.3% from the free throw line. But those other two areas shooting from the floor, overall the team's struggling at 35%. Who's the leading scorers for this team? Well, there's really two dominant scorers, and that really seems to be the key cornerstones of this Graves County team. One is Hannah Glisson, and the other is Morgan Alexander. When you look at those two Lady Eagles, they're leading the way right now. Hannah Glisson's averaging 14.7 per game, and Morgan Alexander is averaging 13.2. From there, it kind of drops down. You got Kinsley Burgess, she's averaging 7. Ginger Martin, she's coming in there, she's averaging about 4. Chloe Scott, she's averaging 3. And Kaylee Winfrey is averaging 3 as well. So overall, the main scorers on this two team is Glisson and Alexander. And when you drop down a little bit and look at the percentage that they're shooting from the floor, that's where you can really see this development or this little bit of struggle from the court overall. Hannah Glisson, who's leading the way, is only shooting 45% from the field overall, and she's the leader on this team. And from there, it drops down considerably. Morgan Alexander, who I mentioned, is the number 2 scorer. She's only shooting 34% from the field. Kinsley Burgess, who's the number 3 shooter, she's only shooting 33% from the field. So when you look at it overall, you can see where these shooting struggles are. When you look outside the arc, I think another number, Eric, that really jumped out at me, Hannah Glisson is the only player on this squad that's averaging better than 33% from outside the arc. She's averaging 37%. She's made 24 out of 64 so far this season. Morgan Alexander, the other big scorer for this team, she's only averaging 31% outside the arc. And then the third scorer, Kinsley Burgess, she's only averaging 29. So when you look at it shooting-wise from the field, Eric, I think that's a big advantage tonight for the Mustangs, particularly when we talk about the suffocating defense that this Lady Mustang team has shown all year long. Looking at it from a free throw standpoint, overall, Hannah Glisson, she's up at 81%. Kinsey Burgess, she's at 75%, and then it kind of drops down from there. So overall, you really only have two main free throw shooters on the floor as far as, and let me include Morgan Alexander there at 86%. That's your main three shooters for the team. That's the main three from the free throw line. I will say, Eric, they're up there north of 75%, so all three of them. So one of the things is the Lady Mustangs do not want to do tonight is put them on the free throw line much. It's really the best shooting that this team has overall. When you look at it from a rebounding standpoint, nothing really jumped out at me. They're averaging 25 rebounds a game. It's about what the Lady Mustangs do. You know, overall, Hannah Glisson is their leading rebounder at four and a half rebounds a game, and then it kind of drops off from there. So not any dominant player in the paint for this Graves County team either.
It is a little bit different makeup from what we have seen in the past for Graves County. Let's go ahead and jump into our Brandon Clifton Allstate Insurance for Success. You're always in good hands with McCracken County Allstate agent Brandon Clifton in Paducah. The first one for McCracken County, play Lady Mustang aggressive defense.
Yeah, Eric, we've seen it all season long. We saw it dominate last Friday night over there at Tillman. We saw it dominate again on Tuesday night against St. Mary's. I think the thing is, you know, I break it down this way. The Lady Mustangs normally have a height advantage. They do again tonight. But it's really not just the height. It's really the length of these Lady Mustangs players, particularly Claire Johnson, Mickey Buchanan, and Reagan Hill. They just really have a long wingspan, all three of them. They do a great job cutting down the passing lanes and ended up stealing the ball or at least knocking it out of its rotation enough that you can get a steal from it from another one of the players. We've seen it all season long. And so what that defense equates to, you know, Eric, what it does is it just breaks into other things, and it particularly fast break points. But I think the key for that aggressive defense tonight will be a concentration and a focus on just making sure they keep Glisson and Alexander shut down for the evening.
Also for McCracken County tonight, looking at solid half-court offense and three contributors on offense at the very least.
Yeah, I think the situation I look at on a solid half-court offense, Eric, you know, a lot of the points have been coming from fast breaks. I think tonight we'll have to play a little tougher team, so we're going to have to settle down and play some good half-court offense. And the other thing is you want that contribution from the other three starters. Coach Civil's talked about it the other night on Wednesday night. Ava Hughes, Reagan Hill, and Jaden Skaggs, they need to contribute.
That is your Brandon Clifton Allstate Insurance for Success. You're always in good hands with McCracken County Allstate agent Brandon Clifton. It's now time for our national anthem, which is brought to you by Rudy's Farm Center, your locally owned farm, industrial, and hardware store in Kemmel. Go check out the Rudy family at Rudy's Farm Center, your locally owned farm, industrial, and hardware store in Kemmel, just 10 minutes from the McCracken County High School campus on Highway 60 in Paducah. We are going to, in a moment, actually turn it to Coach Scott Sibbles as he has got to give it a basketball to Claire Johnson. As she is being honored at half court and got a basketball. And in just a moment.
Also, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, the Lady Mustang seniors would like to present Coach Scott Sibbles with a special recognition plaque. Coach Scott Sibbles was named the 2022-23 NFHS Kentucky Girls.
And Coach Scott Sibbles being nominated last year as the Coach of the Year. The seniors are with Coach Scott Sibbles, and he gets a great ovation from the folks here at Strawberry Hills Pharmacy Arena. And just like that, his parents chime in as well, saying, "Go Mustangs." Good to hear from Scott and Carol Sibbles. And so congratulations very much indeed for Coach Sibbles, as he is on the big board as well. It's time now for our national anthem, brought to you by Rudy's Farm Center. It's 10 minutes from the McCracken County High School campus on Highway 60 in Paducah. It's Rudy's Farm Center's national anthem. The national anthem brought to you by Rudy's Farm Center, your locally owned farm, industrial, and hardware store in Kemmel. Let's go ahead and jump into the starting lineups for tonight. And with that, Daryl Good. It's First Region Tournament Basketball. It is that kind of atmosphere here tonight. We are ready for Graves County and McCracken County. As TJ moves in, the tip's in the air, controlled by McCracken County, and the Lady Mustangs will bring it into the front court. It looks to be man-to-man defense from Graves County as it goes straight away to Ava Hughes. Now left side to Claire Johnson. Johnson using a right-hand dribble, goes into a double team, gives it off to Buchanan, right side to Skaggs. Good to see her back. Jaden into the lane. Her floater is just in and out. Buchanan puts it up, no good. Skaggs gets it back. She's surrounded. It will be a jump ball that will go back to Graves County. Lady Mustangs come up empty on their opening possession. Now they'll bring out the trap with the jump ball, and they'll be able to set up in the 2-2-1. It is Graves County in the backcourt trying to get it into the front court, and in the backcourt with it, it's Hannah Glisson. As Glisson in some trouble, goes on the right-hand side to Morgan Alexander, back to Glisson, and Glisson turns it over as it will go back to McCracken County. An early turnover for Hannah Glisson.
Pressure defense, Eric. That's what we talked about. That's what we want to see out of these Lady Mustangs, and that right there is the start you want to get in the first 60 seconds of this first quarter.
As Claire Johnson goes all the way to the rim, gives it left side to Hughes. She pump fakes, penetrates. Her jumper's partially blocked, recovered by Graves County. On the return, it's Morgan Alexander. As Alexander straight away, she'll take a contested three, no good. Rebound comes back to Graves County. Shot put up, no good. Rebound back to McCracken County. Lady Mustangs want to push it the other way. Mookie Buchanan lost it for a moment, gets it back. Now Buchanan, a baseline drive, all the way to the rim, puts it up and in.
Well, nice play by Mickey. That was a heck of a rebound down there on the defensive end for Mickey to come down with.
Lady Mustangs on top 2-0, a minute into this contest. Into the front court, Glisson now goes on the right-hand side to Alexander. She goes into the corner. That is a jump shot from Scott, no good. Rebound comes back to McCracken County. Lady Mustangs want to push it. Buchanan all the way to the rim. Nobody stopped her, but she missed a layup. Rebound comes back to Claire Johnson, though, and Claire Johnson will bring it back straight away. Crosses over her dribble, goes straight away to Buchanan. Buchanan now uses her dribble, goes to Skaggs. She pump fakes, uses the dribble, goes back to Buchanan, as Buchanan now brings it on the left side. She stops. Mid-range jump shot's too strong. Rebound comes back to Graves County. It is going to be bringing it up Glisson. 2-0 McCracken County, almost two minutes, into this one. Glisson goes on the left-hand side over towards Burgess. Now on the right-hand side towards Alexander. Uses a left-hand dribble towards the top of the key. Picks up the dribble, goes back to Glisson, back to Alexander, left side to Burgess. Her left side three, short. Rebound is going to come down to Hill. She clears it to Johnson. Lady Mustangs want to push it. Johnson into the front court, crosses it over all the way to the rim, puts it up no good, but she's fouled. And so Claire Johnson will go shoot two. That foul on Hannah Glisson.
Yeah, Eric, I want to comment on it. That was the first foul of the game here on Hannah Glisson. Like I said, she's a leading scorer on this team. I'm sure the Graves County staff does not want to see Hannah Glisson get in early foul trouble here in the first quarter.
First free throw from Claire is perfect. Makes it 3-0 McCracken County. Ginger Martin checks in for the Lady Eagles. Lady Mustangs, Claire Johnson, one more free throw. Second free throw is no good. Rebound comes down to Graves County as it clears up the floor to Glisson. As Glisson on the right-hand side goes now straight away to Burgess. And she has it poked away, stolen by Johnson. All the way to the rim, layup's gone. Claire Johnson finishes with another left-hand layup, and it's a timeout for Graves County. It just looks early on. Graves County not able to handle this McCracken County defensive pressure.
They're not. And, Eric, what we saw right there, you know, I talked pregame really about the length of Claire Johnson, Mickey Buchanan, and Reagan Hill. Really, not only do they have a height advantage at 5'10 plus, but these young ladies, they just got a long reach. And we saw that with Claire, you know, right there. The Graves County player tried to throw it over Claire Johnson's head, and that's just not going to happen in this ball game. And Claire Johnson ended up intercepting that pass, making what I want to call now her famous left-handed layup that she makes consistently in these games. And I got to give credit to Reagan Hill. That was a nice rebound, Eric. Last time, Reagan did the same thing. She was able to reach over the Graves County player, who really had better position for that rebound, but Reagan's reach helped her to get that last defensive rebound.
So Graves County trailing 5-0, now coming out of the timeout, breaking it into the front court as Glisson goes baseline. Her shot put up no good, but she's fouled, and that will send Hannah Glisson to the foul line to shoot two. Lady Mustangs off to a 5-0 lead, 5:24 in this opening quarter. Glisson will shoot two. As the first free throw from the 5'7 junior is good. One more coming for Glisson. And it's good. She makes them both. 5-2, McCracken County. 5:20 in this opening quarter. Claire Johnson into the front court for McCracken County as she has it on the left-hand side. She's going to fire left side three and bury it. Claire Johnson from deep makes it 8-2. Graves County on the return is in the backcourt with it. It's Burgess. Now it comes into the front court. Glisson has another turnover taken away by McCracken County, then knocked out of bounds by Graves County. It will go to the Lady Mustangs.
Yeah, Eric, that was a hustle play by Claire Johnson there. Claire got all the way back down court there and ended up knocking that pass really out of control there and then off a Graves County player for a turnover.
It will be Ava Hughes for McCracken County. She goes off a high screen, gives it off to Buchanan, puts down the dribble, comes straight away with it, trying to avoid a double team. Buchanan goes on the left side to Hughes. Hughes now cross court to Skaggs. She pump fakes, penetrates into a trap. Her shot no good, but she's fouled. Nice job by Jaden Skaggs getting the pump fake, get her defender in the air and penetrate to the rim.
Yeah, Eric, I like what we've seen out of Jaden so far. You know, a lot of times Jaden sits up outside the arc. She's good at shooting three-pointers, but this is the second time in this first quarter we've seen her drive the ball towards the rim and try to get off a good shot. I think one of the things, Eric, I'm excited to see Jaden Skaggs back, as you and I mentioned. She wasn't able to play on Tuesday evening, so it's good to see Jaden Skaggs back in the starting lineup here on Friday night.
Second free throw from Skaggs is no good. Rebound comes down to Graves County. 9-2 lead for the Lady Mustangs. Graves County facing pressure. It is going to be in the backcourt. Glisson with it as she goes through a double team. Almost lost it again. Comes up to Graves County on the left side. Martin as she floats it now out top to Kemp. Kemp on the right side to Alexander. As Alexander using a left-hand dribble back to Kemp. On the left-hand side, it goes to Glisson. Straight away, now right side to Alexander. Patience here from the Lady Eagles. Kemp now on the left side. Gets it back. She'll fire a straightaway three that's way off. It comes back to Graves County underneath as it comes down the left-hand side. Glisten, her three, no good. Rebound is loose. Comes down to McCracken County. Lady Mustangs want to push it. Claire stops. She'll fire a straightaway three and bury it.
Ooh, Claire's off to a hot start, Eric. We're always talking about all the layups that Claire makes off these turnovers. But tonight she's starting off hot outside the arc. That's two for two outside the arc for Claire Johnson. She was determined there. She couldn't find the lane to drive it down the paint to get a layup, and she just pulled up there at the top of the key for her second three-pointer so far tonight.
And that's what makes her the best guard in Western Kentucky and one of the best in the entire state.
It does. I mean, one of the things is we can't say enough about Claire's play. Like I said, Eric, I love to watch Claire play defense. She's always interfering with the passes of the other team, like with her length, and then she turns it into fast break points. Either she does it on her own or she makes sure she gets the pass out. And I think, Eric, that's one of the things we got to compliment Claire on. You know, tonight she got that award for 500 assists. Claire's not stingy with the ball. She wants to find that open shooter, whether it's herself or one of her other teammates, and she does an excellent job at it overall. And so I got to give Claire a lot of credit. But one thing we haven't seen, Eric, is Claire dominate outside the arc like we're seeing so far in this first quarter. But certainly, Eric, when we get to see Claire play, we're seeing the top guard in Western Kentucky. We're seeing it. We're seeing a show so far here in this first quarter.
No doubt about it. Lady Mustangs jump out to a 12-2 lead. 3:50 in this opening quarter. Graves County the possession as Ella Kemp will cross the timeline into a trap. Nearly threw it away, goes to Glisten. As Glisten double-teamed on the right-hand side, gets by her defender. Now stops, goes back out to Kemp, left side to Alexander. She puts a left-hand dribble down, goes to the rim, a little up and under layup. It's partially blocked by the rim, comes back to McCracken County. Buchanan on the return as Mickey stops straight away. Now penetrates, stops again. Her jump shot, she is long, no good. Rebound back to Graves County. Alexander for the Lady Eagles using a right-hand dribble. Now it switches to the left hand, goes to Kemp. Or I'm sorry, to Glisten, excuse me. As Glisten now straight away to Kemp. Swung right side to Alexander. Back to Kemp. Now left side poked away for a moment and out of bounds off McCracken County. It'll stay with Graves County.
Eric, we got to give credit to Eric to almost stealing that pass. That's Lazaria Bowen. She's in the game right now. It's the first time we've seen Lazaria so far in the game. She's in for Ava Hughes. We know she did a great job Tuesday night against St. Mary's.
Graves County with the ball, trailing McCracken County 12-2. As it is, Alexander gives it off at the foul line, and they throw it straight to the McCracken bench. This Graves County ball club right now not able to handle this McCracken County pressure.
No, and that was Reagan Hill. She put a pressure on the ball handler there and caused her to throw that ball out of bounds for another turnover for the Lady Mustangs.
Graves County the possession as Johnson hands it off. Nope, keeps it. He's going to take another step back three and bury it. Claire Johnson continues to do well. It's 15-2. 2:38 in this opening quarter. Yet another reason why she's the best guard in Western Kentucky. Graves County the possession. Alexander stops. Long-range jump shot, no good. Rebound comes down to Hill. Clears it to Johnson. Claire into the front court, all the way to the rim. She stops, turns, gives it out to Buchanan. Mickey into the lane herself, gives it down low to Hill. Reagan's layup is perfect.
Oh, that was nice work, Eric. That was great work between Claire Johnson over to Mickey Buchanan. Looked like Mickey was going to take about a 10-foot jumper there. The defender pulled out on her, left Reagan Hill wide open at the rim, and Mickey was able to see her wide open, dump that ball off of Reagan Hill to get an easy basket right at the rim.
This is a nightmare start for McCracken County, or for Graves County, I'm sorry. You're facing the back-to-back Region 1 champs, trying to make a statement here against them, and so far they are not.
Yeah, Eric, I think the situation is, I want to make a comment. You know, this is the third time here at Strawberry Hill that we've witnessed these Lady Mustangs. As we know, they had a game, they got off to a 40-2 start in the first quarter. We've had another game so far this season that got off to a 15-2 start in the first quarter. And here we're setting with 2 minutes and 18 seconds left, and they're up 17-2. So this is the third time we've seen this type of defense hold a team to nearly 0 points in the first quarter.
17-2, Lady Mustangs on top, 2:15 in the opening quarter. Alongside Jimmy Garrett, I'm Eric Chumbler. Thanks for joining us as Alexander has it in the front court. Now on the right-hand side, it goes to Burgess, down low, layup up and in by Winfrey. So Winfrey gets the Eagles' first field goal of the game. It's 17-4, excuse me, minute 56 in this opening quarter. Buchanan out top with it for McCracken County. She crosses over her dribble, stops at the foul line. Mid-range jump shot, a little bit forced, no good. Rebound comes down to Graves County. On the return, it is the Lady Eagles on the right-hand side. Pump fake, penetrate, as into the corner it goes to Winfrey. Back out now to Alexander. As Alexander almost carried the basketball, facing a five count, now gets some separation between her and Bowling. Goes on the right side to Scott. Her jump shot, no good. Rebound comes back to Swinford. She clears it to Johnson. Clear into the front court for McCracken County. Stops, uses her dribble. And now crosses it over against her defender. Nice Euro step layups, perfect. Graves County has no answer for Claire Johnson. It is 19-4. On the left-hand side it goes Alexander. Short corner now to Winfrey. As Winfrey picks up the dribble, but nearly thrown away. Bolin almost got the steal. Now Alexander on the right-hand side to Burgess. Now it goes into the corner. Three no good. Rebound back to McCracken County as Skaggs into the front court. 45 seconds left here in the opening quarter. It is going to be towards Johnson as Claire crosses it over a couple of times. Now straight away. 33 seconds here in the first quarter. Claire Johnson gets a high screen. She stops, gives it off to Mickey Buchanan. Now it's knocked loose. It's going to be a jump ball that will go to McCracken County with 25 seconds left. Ava Hughes will check back in. Also, Ella Kemp for Graves County. Great start for the Lady Mustangs. Not so much for the Lady Eagles here. 25 seconds in the first. McCracken will have it underneath its own basket, leading 19-4. Bolin to Buchanan. Buchanan to Swinford. She'll take a mid-range jump shot. No good. Rebound comes back to Graves County. Lady Eagles on the push. On the right-hand side, it's Kemp. Kemp straight away. Now comes left side to Alexander to Burgess. Left side three is no good. Rebound comes down to Hughes. She races the other way with 10 seconds left. Hughes gives it off to Bolin. Bolin, a baseline drive, gives it off out to Johnson. Left side three, it's no good. Rebound back to Graves County, and that will do it for the first quarter. After one quarter of play, McCracken County leads McCracken, or great, McCracken County leads Graves County, 19-4, and overall a great start for the Lady Mustangs.
Yeah, Eric, that was a great start. We got to give a lot of credit to Claire Johnson there. And if she didn't miss that three-pointer right there at the buzzer, Eric, she shot 100% from the field in that first quarter. I mean, Claire looks like the best guard in Kentucky right now. She's playing excellent overall, both inside and outside. But I think, Eric, the difference in this game, when I look up at the scoreboard at 19-4, and that was one of the things that you just commented on just a moment ago, that third and fourth point that basket made was really the only basket that Lady Eagles made from the field. The only other 2 points they had so far in this first quarter were from the free throw line. So, you know, just think about how dominating that defense is when you held a team like Graves County to just one basket from the field in a whole quarter. So, you know, we talked about the Lady Mustangs defense. I use the term now, it's just a suffocating defense. We've seen it so far in these first 8 minutes. And when you hold a team to just a single basket from the field throughout a whole quarter, Eric, you can't say anything but give a lot of credit to these Lady Mustangs and the hustle they're putting in for Coach Sivils.
So Lady Mustangs up 19-4 as we start this second quarter. Graves County starting with the possession. As Burgess will inbound it to Kemp, we're underway. McCracken County coming out in an extended trap defense. Goes into the corner now to Alexander. She thought about a three, picks up her dribble. Now gives it up to Glisson, to Kemp. Guarded by Hughes. Great defense by Hughes as Glisson gives it back up just in front of half court. Now on the right side to Kemp. Kemp on the wing now to Burgess. As Burgess picks up her dribble, gives it now straight away. As it comes down the left-hand side, that goes towards Winfrey. Her shot no good. Rebound back to McCracken County. As it is the Lady Mustangs with it as Johnson goes on the left-hand side. Straight away Buchanan. She's wide open. Her three's too strong. Rebound Lazaria Bolin, though, goes up strong. Puts it in, but she traveled with it. It will go back to Graves County. She shuffled her pivot foot before putting it back up, but Graves County continuing to struggle on the defensive boards.
They are. You got to give credit to Lady Mustangs. That's one thing I've not mentioned so far, but the Lady Mustangs have done an excellent job down here getting the boards on the offensive end, and that was just another one of them there by Lazaria Bolin.
So it goes into the front court as Alexander gives it off on the left-hand side. Now back out top it goes And now on the wing to Burgess. As Burgess goes in the corner to Kemp, guarded by Buchanan. Kemp picks up her dribble, back to Burgess. Now out top it goes to Glisson. Glisson has it taken away again, knocked loose again. Glisson able to get it back. Down low it goes onto the block as a reach-in foul is going to be called, I believe, on Reagan Hill. It will be the Mustangs' first team foul of the quarter. That is Reagan's second.
It's a little concerning, Eric. I think, you know, one thing we know, Coach Sybils has grown his bench, but Reagan Hill's a big part of the play in the paint for the Lady Mustangs.
No doubt. Alexander long three, no good. Rebound comes down to Buchanan. They race the other way. Mickey into the front court. Mickey crosses it over, stops at the foul line. Backdoor cut to Johnson. Layup is good. Claire picking up where she left off. She's got 16. Graves County, the possession is into the front court. It goes. Glisson behind the back dribble. Now works into the lane, stops, gets her man in the air, her layup up, no good. Rebound comes back to McCracken County. Missed a wide open layup. Rebound back to Lady Mustangs. Wide open is Hill. Layup is good. As Reagan Hill finishes at the rim, and Coach Lyndon Dunning not happy. Lady Mustangs out to a 23-4 lead and really just making Graves County uncomfortable both sides of the floor.
Yeah, Eric, you know, one of the things is when Graves County came out of that quarter right there and started this second quarter, they were able to get a couple shots there. They missed them both. The Lady Mustangs came down with the easy rebounds there and brought it down the court and converted it into points. So, you know, if you take overall this first quarter and then let's say 2 minutes into this second quarter, you know, Claire's missed a three-pointer, Mickey's missed a couple jump shots, and Lazaria Boland had that one travel right there after she got the offensive rebound. But other than those situations, Eric, you've got to say so far these Lady Mustangs have nearly played flawless in these first 10 minutes of this game.
No other way to put it. It is a lopsided matchup here so far. 6:08 in the second quarter. Plenty of time left for Graves County, but they've got a lot of things they need to adjust in order to either slow down this offense or speed up of their own. And so it will be Graves County with the possession trailing 23-4. Glisson in the backcourt with it, now facing full court pressure, gives it to Kemp on the right side, poked away for a moment, but Alexander able to get there, now facing a trap. Alexander throws it back towards Glisson, now on the right-hand side it goes, that is to Martin. Underneath, a jump shot from Burgess, no good, rebound comes down to a jump ball, that will go over to McCracken County.
Eric, we got to give a little bit of credit tonight to Skaggs. She's got a number of rebounds down there
on the
defensive end. That's normally not what you see out of Skaggs, but she's doing an excellent job tonight on the boards down on the defensive end.
No doubt. She is wonderful. And good to have her back in the lineup as it goes to Buchanan straight away. Uses her dribble. Cut off. Goes back now towards the foul line. Turns towards the block. Her layup's perfect, and she's fouled.
And, Eric, I think that's just a sign of Graves County. I think, unfortunately, form number 15 there for Graves County, I think that is Ginger Martin. She just put her hands up to the bench over at Graves County, like saying, what do I do? Because Mickey just worked her way all the way around her and just worked her in the paint to the rim. And I got to give her credit. What do you do with Mickey Buchanan? That was an excellent play.
As Buchanan's free throw is good. 26-4. Lady Mustangs on top. As Graves County the possession. It is going to be in the backcourt. Glisson with Alexander, who races into the front court for Graves County. Floats it down low, as now with it down low is Martin. Back to Alexander, hands it off. Now goes on the right-hand side as it is Glisson. Her jump shot no good, but she draws a foul. And so Glisson will go to the foul line to shoot two. Lady Mustangs up 26-4. There's two free throws coming from Glisson. First free throw is good. She will have one more. The second free throw from Hannah Glisson is good. Lady Mustangs up 26-6. 5:15 in this second quarter, as it is going to be into the front court for McCracken County, Ava Hughes. As Ava, using her right-hand dribble, goes top of the key to Johnson. She's going to take a long three. It's no good. Rebound comes back to Reed, though. Then she has it poked away by Graves County. Lady Eagles on the return as Ella Kemp into the front court for Graves County. Picks up her dribble, goes to Glisson. right there on the McCracken logo. As Wilson, guarded by Hughes, left side to Alexander. Alexander using a right-hand dribble, crosses it over to the left. Now on the baseline, it goes to Martin. Martin loses it, taken away by Buchanan. Up the floor, it goes to Johnson. Claire crosses it over against Glisson. Nice spin move. Layup's perfect.
Woo. Eric, I don't know what you say about that move Claire made there. I think she did two full 360 spins in the paint before she put that up on the glass.
28-6, Lady Mustangs in control. Claire's got 18. Up the floor, it goes for Graves County, poked out of bounds. Great defense once again from McCracken County. Claire Johnson has scored three times the amount of points right now of Graves County.
Wow, Eric, I just don't know what you say about it other than you're seeing one of the finest guards play in a long time out here in Western Kentucky and certainly for the Mustangs.
No doubt about it. It is going to be Ella Kemp on the right-hand side. Burgess picks it up, goes straight away to Glisson. Now at the foul line, it's fed. Back out top, right side, a three from Burgess is good. First, or only the second field goal of the game for Graves County. First from deep, 28-9, Lady Mustangs on top. Claire Johnson gets a high screen from Reed, gives it off to Buchanan. She'll fire a left side three, off no good. Rebound comes down to Graves County. On the return for Graves County, it is Kemp. It's Kemp, gives it up to Glisson, but she nearly traveled with it, goes back to Kemp. Now swung on the left-hand side to Burgess. Now on the block it goes. Is a layup up, no good. Rebound back to McCracken County. Buchanan up the floor, goes to Ava Hughes. Ava to the rim, put it up, miss a layup. Rebound back to Graves County. It is going to be Glisson. As Glisson goes on to the wing, that is to Burgess. Back straight it goes to Glisson. Swung into the corner now to Shea. As Shea. Top of the key, and she traveled with it as she shuffled her feet ever so slightly. Lazaria Boland checks back in. Ava Hughes getting a breather from McCracken County. Lady Mustangs right now on top, 28-9, with 3 minutes left in this second quarter. As up the floor it goes, Buchanan. She attacks, goes to Boland, straight away to Johnson. Her straightaway three, no good. Rebound comes out to Graves County. Up on the left-hand side it goes to Glisson. As Glisson ends it off out top to Kemp. Back to Glisson. Pump fakes, goes now into the corner to Shea. Her three, got it. Graves County, their first run of the game, back-to-back threes. It's 28-12. It will be Johnson in the backcourt with it. With Boland, and Lazaria goes back to Johnson. Claire crosses it over, gets by her defenders, all the way to the rim, off the glass, no good. Rebound comes back to Graves County. A little bit forced there by Claire Johnson. Is Ella Kemp on the left-hand side now to Shea. Now into the corner, Kemp pump fakes, uses a left-hand dribble, crosses it over with her right hand. Out to Burgess in the corner, looking for the post. Nice entry, but it's blocked by Buchanan. Recovered by Graves, blocked again by Buchanan. Comes to Skaggs, up to Johnson. Left-hand layup's perfect. And that's what Graves County can't do. They cannot keep up with McCracken County in transition. It's 30-12. Graves County on the return. As it is going to be Glisson between two defenders. Goes on the left-hand side. Burgess, mid-range jump shot, no good. McCracken looking to run again. Buchanan will bring it up for the Lady Mustangs. As Buchanan gets by her defender. Nice pass to Laser. Boland's jump shot, she missed it. Rebound back to Graves County, but it's going to be a foul on Reed.
That, Eric's one of the few missed opportunities this quarter. You know, Claire's missed a couple three-point opportunities there. Ava's missed a layup, and that's really the only fourth missed opportunity the Lady Mustangs have had so far down here on the offensive end of the court.
And so, checking in is going to be Megan Swinford for McCracken County. Lady Mustangs up 30-12. I think the crowd was expecting a little bit better of a game in this one. It is kind of quiet at the moment as it is another Graves County turnover back to McCracken County. It is a big crowd, but right now with this lopsided start, it is very much a quiet crowd. As Boland in the backcourt, now Johnson into the front court. Back to Boland. She stops, gives it off in the corner to Swinford. Back now to Buchanan. As Buchanan
get met by a double team to Johnson. As Claire all the way into the lane, her floater up, no good. Rebound out of bounds off of McCracken County. It will go to Graves County. Right now it feels like Claire might be forcing a couple of it instead of letting the offense come to her a little bit.
She did there a little bit. I think Claire had such a hot first quarter there that she's really wanting to keep shooting the ball. And she's went a little bit cold here in the second quarter. But as we know for Claire, she'll cool down here and she'll get warm back up here before this half is over and put some more baskets in for the Lady Mustangs.
On the left-hand side, a three coming from Shea, no good. Rebound back to her, though, as she goes into the lane, floats one up into the middle of the lane, and it goes. Sydney Shea gets her own rebound and puts it back up. 35 seconds in this second quarter. Lady Mustangs up 30-14. Bowen splits a double team, goes now to Swinford, out to Buchanan. She fires the left side three and buries it.
A nice shot by Mickey Buchanan. That was a nice three-pointer there.
33-14, Lady Mustangs by 19. As Graves County with the possession, Sydney Shea into the lane. Her pass is kicked by McCracken County. It'll stay with Graves County.
Eric, that would have been a nice soccer move there by Mickey Buchanan. She kicked that ball and caught it all at the same time.
Acrobatic, athletic. As Graves County will inbound it. Lady Eagles the possession. As straight away, it's Glisson. 5 seconds left, feeds it down into the post, knocked away, and stolen by McCracken County. As a three-quarter court heave is close, but no good, and that will do it for the first half. A lopsided first half in favor of the Lady Mustangs, leading it 33-14. We come back, we'll give you the first half scoring. Estes Chiropractic, second half adjustments, next, 99.5 The Fan.
We understand that life happens, and sometimes you need a little financial boost. That's why at C-Plant Federal Credit Union, we offer low-rate loans tailored to your needs. Whether it's a car loan, a personal loan, or anything in between, we've got you covered. Learn more at cplant.com or visit any of C-Plant Federal Credit Union's 9 local branches. Member NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
Rudy's Farm Center is your locally owned farm, industrial, and hardware store in Keppel. Now, the Rudy family is proud to be a part of Mustang Nation. Why don't you come out and enjoy a bag of the famous popcorn? It's just 10 minutes from the school campus out on Highway 60. While you're there, take a good look at the selection of Traeger wood pellet grills, a great addition for your tailgate party. At Rudy's Farm Center, down Highway 60 in Keppel.
Flooring is incredibly important when it comes to sports. It's also incredibly important when it comes to your home or business. You gotta see Flooring America for a full line of residential and commercial carpet, vinyl, laminate, area rugs, and custom tile. Their professional installers are fully insured. They have the area's largest selection of quality floor coverings for integrity, quality, and professional service. See Greg Dilworth at Flooring America, 5150 Heartland Drive, FlooringAmericaPaducah.com.
Just like your fingerprint, your heartbeat is unique to you. And that's how your heart care should be too. So at Baptist Health, we focus on your specific cardiac needs, from preventive care to some of the most advanced procedures. For your one-of-a-kind heart, choose the one hospital system more people trust for their heart care. Baptist Health. It's care centered on you. Visit baptisthealth.com/heartcare.
At CFSB, we're your ultimate business partner. Our business development team is ready to help you with personal banking that suits your unique goals, along with top-notch business services to streamline your operations. Need capital to fuel your business dreams? Our business lending solutions have gotten you covered. From small startups to established enterprises, we're here to support your growth every step of the way. Simplify your business journey today. Visit any of our 8 banking centers or explore our website at yourlifeyourbank.com to discover the convenience of a true one-stop shop. Your success is our business. Together, let's make it happen. CFSB, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Craig Culver on Culver's Salted Caramel Concrete Mixers.
Summer just isn't complete without this treat. We take our frozen custard and add salted caramel. Then pick your favorite mix in. Cookie dough, brownie pieces, or how about Reese's Peanut Butter Cup? We spin it by hand. I love seeing that caramel swirl through the custard. There it is. Come on in for the Culver's Salted Caramel Concrete Mixer. Welcome to Delicious.
Stop in at Culver's on Highway 60 in Paducah. When it comes to opening a new bank account, I have very high opening requirements. Amazingly, FNB Bank's Your Start Bundle Checking Plus Savings pulls out all the stops. A 2.25% APY on your first $15,000, free nationwide ATMs, a great mobile app, and more. Hey, when you meet a bank that complies with your terms, it's not about small print. It's your big goals and dreams. Get your start at FNB. APY is annual percentage yield. Standard rate of 0.20% APY will apply to balances over $15,000. See bank for terms and conditions. FNB Bank, member FDIC.
Back here at Strawberry Hills Pharmacy Arena on the campus of McCracken County High School, we're at the half. McCracken County is on top of Graves County, 33-14. Let's take a look at the first half scoring. And once again with that, Jimmy Garrett.
So we'll take a look at Graves County first. Overall tonight, just 14 points on the board. Leading scorer tonight for the Lady Eagles, Sydney Shea. She has a total of 5 points. Second leading scorer tonight for the Lady Eagles is Hannah Glisson. She has four. All four of those have come from the free throw line. No shots made so far from the field. Kaylee Winfrey, she has two. And Kenzie Burgess has a total of three. Taking a look at the Lady Mustangs, interesting enough, Eric, with 33 points on the board, only four Mustangs. Lady Mustangs have scored so far this evening. Mickey Buchanan, she's got a total of eight. She had six of those points there in the second quarter. Reagan Hill's having a good game. She's got a basket in each quarter. She's got a total of four. Jaden Skaggs, who we are glad to see back in the starting lineup tonight, she has 1 point from the free throw line. Tonight, Eric, this has been like me and you talked the other night. The St. Louis Rams used to be the greatest show on turf. You know, I'm not sure what you rhyme with Claire Johnson, but it is certainly a great show to watch. So far, she's got 20 points on the board. Looks like she had 14 of those in the first quarter and another 6 points in the second quarter. So for Claire right now, she's got 20 points. So Claire's continued to dominate as we've seen her all week long in these games. Today, she's got to play a lot more minutes than she did against Paducah Tillman and St. Mary's. But what a show Claire put on, particularly, Eric, in that first quarter.
No doubt, no doubt. She had quite the performance for McCracken County. As we turn now to our second half adjustments brought to you by the Back Brothers, Kevin and Kelly Estes of Estes Chiropractic, Central Avenue in Paducah. And for the Lady Mustangs, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. A lot of the same.
Yeah, Eric, you know, one of the things is we hate to sound a little like a broken record. We've talked in these games about the Lady Mustangs playing Lady Mustang basketball, and that's what they've done here. This is the third consecutive game, and they're doing a great job here tonight. And so, as I summarized on my sheet, Eric, it's just a lot of the same. That's all we need to continue to do, continue to play that suffocating defense that we see throughout both full court and half court defense. Continue to make those turnovers into layups and easy points at the basket. And then one of the things is, Eric, that this has been one of the first games in a couple weeks. The Lady Mustangs are doing a great job shooting the ball outside the arc. I think Claire's got 3 three-pointers. I know Nikki Buchanan has one as well. So overall, the Lady Mustangs are picking up a lot of points outside the arc. But they just need to continue to do the same thing they did in this first half.
And also for McCracken County, continued good execution on offense.
Yeah, Eric, and I want to talk about that. Similar to what I talked about at St. Mary's, I think it's really for two groups. I think you want to continue to see it out of this starting group that we saw here in the first half. I think there were a couple opportunities there where there could have been an extra pass or two to find another open shooter. So a little bit of opportunity there coming out of that second quarter. But I think somewhere in this game, if it continues the scoring difference being between 20 and 30 points, somewhere in there, Coach Sybils is going to put that second group in. I want to see that good execution out of the second group. We saw a lot of good execution out of them at St. Mary's on Tuesday night. I want to see that continue here tonight against Graves County. It's a development of this team for later in the season. I think it also shows good signs for development of this team next season.
And so that is your Estes Chiropractic second half adjustments. When you need that back adjustment, go see the Back Brothers, Kevin and Kelly Estes of Estes Chiropractic, Central Avenue in Paducah. It's 33-14 at the half. The Lady Mustangs on top. And overall, if you're McCracken County, it's much of the same as what we've seen all year. Great ball movement, very nice execution, and just shutting things down on the defensive end.
Yeah, Eric, you know, I like to really harp on that defensive end of it. Like I said in the pregame, and we've been talking about it all season long, like you said, it's the defense of this Lady Mustang team that really complements the offense. You know, one of the things is you can look at them statistically and say the Lady Mustangs have this great offense, and certainly they do. But really, it's the foundation is the defense. It's these turnovers that end up being fast break points. It's getting defensive rebounds and throwing it down court and getting fast break points. And so overall, defensively, Eric, and that's one of the things is that, you know, we don't highlight when we look at the stats, but one of the things is we've got to compliment the Lady Mustangs tonight. They've done a great job on the boards. They've done a good job down on the defensive boards. They've gotten a lot of offensive boards and had some second chance opportunities down on this end. One person that I've got to call out on that is Jaden Skaggs. And, you know, Eric, throughout the season, Jaden Skaggs is not one that we normally see dominating the boards, but I've got to give her credit down on the defensive end tonight. She's got at least three, four, maybe five boards for the Lady Mustangs. I think that's key, particularly the fact that Reagan Hill got in a little foul trouble early on and really spent the better part of that first half on the bench. And I got to give Jaden Skaggs credit. She picked up on that rebounding along with Mickey Buchanan while Reagan Hill was out.
That's exactly right. And now McCracken County with the 19-point lead, looking to continue much of that here in the second half and get what would be another Region 1 victory for the Lady Mustangs, as they are on quite this streak against Region 1 opponents. Is the back-to-back Region 1 champs looking to do that once again. Won't be easy, but right now playing like they have that potential for sure. And the boys' game will follow McCracken County and Graves County. The Mustangs quite young, but well ahead of schedule and playing very well as well. Graves County, one of the more veteran teams in the region. And coming in here to McCracken County tonight should be a fun one. That game will be around 7:45 or so right here on 99.5 The Fan. Lady Mustangs on top right now, 33-14. And for McCracken County, the Lady Mustangs will start out on the defensive side, leading by 19, 33-14. And it looks to be the starters once again for McCracken County. Same for Graves County. We are underway in just a moment with the Lady Eagles to inbound, sideline out of bounds at half court. And so it comes in to Hannah Glisson, and into the front court it goes on the left side to Alexander. As she then loses it straight out of bounds, and the turnovers continue for Graves County.
Yeah, Eric, I'm sure for the coaching staff at Graves County, that's not the start they wanted here in the third quarter. They needed to get on the board and get on the board quickly here, and unfortunately, just 7 seconds in there, they've turned the ball over.
And so McCracken County to get it right back. As it is going to be Johnson, had it poked away and stolen. As it comes now straight away on the right side, it goes to Glisson. Glisson now gives it back out top to Burgess, back to Glisson. As Glisson back to Burgess, she'll fire a long three and bury it. Great three from Kinsey Burgess from deep.
Eric, standing here in front, she was 7 feet behind the arc there. She was almost on the out-of-bounds line when she shot that three-pointer.
And so it is going to be McCracken County, the possession right now, leading 33-17. It is going to be on the right-hand side. Now the block, now on the wing to Johnson. Claire using her dribble, goes now into the corner, Buchanan. Buchanan on the block to Hill. She turns into the lane, off the glass, no good, but she's fouled.
It was a well-thought-out play there. It was a nice pass inside. Reagan Hill just came over on that side of the paint where Mickey Buchanan had the ball in the corner along the baseline, and Mickey saw her wide open there. It was a nice pass. The defender did get a little pressure on Reagan and not allow her to get an easy shot off.
And so the free throw from Hill is no good. One more for Reagan. As a second free throw, no good. Rebound comes back to Graves County. Graves County in the backcourt. Lady Mustangs up 33-17. As a right side three coming, no good from Alexander. Tipped around, controlled by a jump ball, I believe, and it will go to McCracken County. Lady Mustangs possession, leading 33-17. So Graves County back in their half-court defense. Looks to be man-to-man defense, potentially. Nope, matchup zone. It is going to be Hughes on the right-hand side to Skaggs. As she traveled with it, she switched her pivot foot, and it goes back to Graves County. Lady Mustangs, go ahead.
So far, it's a little sloppy play by both teams so far, Eric, in this first minute and a half.
It is going to be Graves County. The possession is Alexander on the left-hand side. Takes a baseline drive underneath. A little reverse layup, no good. Rebound comes back to Graves County, but a foul on the rebound by McCracken County. And it will be Lady Eagles underneath their own basket. So Graves County to inbound it, as it is going to be straight away to Glisson. As Glisson goes on the right-hand side to Alexander, as she puts down the dribble, goes back out top to Glisson, swung towards Burgess. Now on the short block to Shea, and knocked out of bounds off Graves County. Well, I'm sorry, off McCracken County. It'll stay with Graves County.
Yeah, Eric, I think you called that right the first time.
It was.
Yeah, I think that was clearly off a Graves County player there, but no harm, no foul there, but I think you called it right the first time.
So it will be Graves County to inbound it. As it comes in on the block, partially poked away, and Graves County now on the deck with it. As it comes back to McCracken County, it's going to be a jump ball. Lady Mustangs on top, 33-17, with 6:03 in this third quarter. Lady Mustangs, a possession up by 16. As Claire Johnson walks it up for McCracken County. Claire goes on the right side to Skaggs. As Skaggs picks up her dribble, goes back to Johnson, swings on the left side to Hughes. As Hughes straight away to Claire Johnson, back to Hughes. As Hughes straight away to Johnson. 33-17, Lady Mustangs yet to score in this third quarter. Comes now to Hill, mid-range jump shot. It's wild, it's no good. Rebound back to McCracken County though. And the Lady Mustangs try again. Johnson goes straight away to Buchanan. To Johnson on the wing. Back out to Buchanan. As Mickey uses a right-hand dribble. Goes to Johnson. McCracken County will reset. Stagnant right now, the Lady Mustangs offense. Not much movement as it goes to Hill. Now baseline drive. Is her shot partially blocked, but she's fouled. You could see if you were in the arena, Coach Scott Sibbles right now, just one word, move.
Yeah. So far, Eric, both teams really have just played at a slower pace than what we saw them play in that first half. And so for the Lady Mustangs, we're not used to seeing them play this slow.
As the first free throw was good. One more free throw. And it's good. Reagan makes them both. And McCracken back on top, 35-17. It is full court pressure from McCracken County. As Graves County yet to get it across the timeline. They've got too soon. Claire Johnson almost gets a steal. And that's a 10-second violation. It will go back to McCracken County.
Yeah, Eric, that was that pressure defense there for, you know, the Graves County. They've done pretty good overall breaking the press. I got to give them credit in that first half, but there, finally, the Lady Mustangs got them on a 10-second call.
35-17, Lady Mustangs on top with 4:50 left in this third quarter. As Johnson goes on the wing to Skaggs. Left side to Claire. She'll fire a left side three. It's no good. Rebound tipped around, controlled by Graves County. Lady Eagles on the return as Glisson. Top of the key. Goes on the right-hand side. A three coming from Burgess. No good. Rebound comes back on the offside for Graves County, though. As it will be Alexander. She had it poked away for a moment, gets it back. Is Alexander in some trouble, gives it off to Burgess. Back out to Alexander, 4:18 left in this third quarter. Now on the block it goes, that is to Scott. Swung on the right-hand side to Glisson. As Glisson now throws it almost out of bounds, but Skaggs actually probably should have just let that one go. Nobody was near it, and she accidentally deflected out of bounds.
She did. There wasn't a Graves County player behind Jaden Skaggs here. She didn't know that, so she tried to deflect the ball, but that would have been a turnover for the Mustangs.
So Graves County to inbound it. As it's poked away for a moment, but Glisson gets it back to Alexander on the right-hand side. And gives it off to the wing to Glisson. Now into the post to Scott. She turns, and her shot blocked by Buchanan. McCracken the other way. Buchanan into the corner to Ava Hughes. Her left side three, no good. Rebound back to Graves County. McCracken not hustling back. Burgess all the way to the rim. Then nice job by Lazaria Bowen to hustle back and get the deflection.
Eric, I think Lazaria heard you, because just when you said the Mustangs aren't hustling back, Lazaria kicked that into high gear there, and she cut that player off from Graves County, would not allow her to get an easy layup, poked it out of her dribble. So I got to give Lazaria Bowen credit, Eric. I think she's listening to you on the air, and she picked up her pace.
As it looked to be a breakaway layup for Graves County, it will be Graves County the possession. Is Ella Kemp for McCracken County, or for Graves County, excuse me. And now towards the left side, it's swung towards Martin. Now right side is Glisson, a running floater up and in. Nice shot by Hannah Glisson.
Eric, is that her first basket from the floor
that
tonight?
That is. Yeah, her first field goal tonight. Lady Mustangs lead at 35-19, 3:10 in this third quarter. It's Claire Johnson on the left-hand side. Goes straight away to Skaggs. Skaggs down low. Her pass deflected out of bounds off Graves County. It'll stay with McCracken County. Bit of a boring third quarter. The crowd right now quite quiet. And what is a huge crowd, I think, expecting a close game tonight. They were not expecting this lopsided result, so far. As Graves County knocks it out of bounds. It has definitely been a one-sided contest so far.
It has, Eric. It is. I think you summarized it. It's been a little bit of a boring third quarter. I think that's what you said. And I've got to agree with you. I mean, there's only 3 minutes left right now. And not a lot of points put up by either team so far in this third quarter.
Skaggs straight away to Johnson. As Claire goes left side to Skaggs. Back to Johnson. As Claire goes on the wing to Lazaria Bowen. Bowen on the wing to Skaggs, and that's a traveling violation. And right now, the Lady Mustangs not looking good.
No, Eric, when I look up at the scoreboard, right now the Lady Mustangs have 34 points, or 35 points, excuse me. You know, they average 61. So unless they have a big fourth quarter, they may not get to that season average 61 points at this pace.
So Graves County, the possession, trying to get it into the front court, and it is a 10-second violation once again. Turnovers are plenty. As it will go back to McCracken County.
I see Coach Civil, as you mentioned, Eric, earlier, who told somebody to move. He had a pretty stern talking with Reagan Hill there and said those very words, move.
Let's see if McCracken County responds. As Lazaria Bowen gives it to Hill. She works towards the low block, gives it out right side to Johnson. As Claire crosses it over, gives it out to Bowen. Bowen into the lane, has it stripped, gets it back, and nearly threw it away. It's deflected by Graves County. It will stay with McCracken County. As the score right now in this third quarter is 5-2. Nearly exactly 6 minutes into it. As it comes in and stolen by Alexander. Alexander on the return. Stops. Looks. Goes out to Glisson. Now straight away to Kemp. To Glisson. Now in the lane to Alexander. Her layup's good. No, came out. Missed a wide open layup. Rebound back to McCracken County. Mickey Buchanan. Nice pass to Hill. Layup's good. Lady Mustangs want a timeout. Coach Scott Simmel's not happy at all with the offensive production of his Lady Mustangs so far in this third quarter.
No, Eric, if I've got you correct, is that 7 points so far total, or 7 points for the Lady Mustangs so far in this quarter? And when you look at that overall, Eric, you know, we've caught a lot of games with the Lady Mustangs. They score a bunch of points overall. So right now for Graves County, one of the things they've got to feel good about as a win for Graves County is they've held the Lady Mustangs to just 37 points nearly through three quarters. So, Eric, I'd have to summarize all season long, that's probably a low point total for the Lady Mustangs at this point in the game.
Want to give a shout-out to good friend, your friend and mine, and great supporter of McCracken County Schools and all the schools in this area. Is the children's pastor at Heartland Church, Brian Phelps, listening in. Good to hear from you, Brian. Actually, he's here tonight. I see him right across the way over there. Good to see you, partner. You can let us know you're listening. Cellular Connection text hotline, 270-557-8223.
270-557-8223, and we'll shout you out courtesy of the Cellular Connection. Lone Oak Road in Paducah. Lady Mustangs on top. 37-19, a minute 25 in this third quarter. A near steal goes through to Alexander as Word checks into the game. Former McCracken County out of the timeout to Alexander on the wing. Also a shout out to Amy Jefford saying, let's go Stangs. Good to hear from you, Amy. Graves County with it is Kemp. McCracken upping the pressure, and it's going to be a little bit of a foul, looks like, on Ava Hughes. That is her first, team's second. So Lady Eagles will inbound it, trailing by 18, 37-19. Minute left in this third quarter. Graves County, it is going to be Glisson. On the wing to Alexander. Picks up the dribble, goes left side to Kemp. Now cross court to Alexander. She takes a baseline drive, gets it now to foul line, nearly poked away, and it is still loose, but Graves County able to corral it. Kemp in some trouble, gives it off now to Martin. To Glisson, her three, no good. Rebound comes down to McCracken County. Claire Johnson races the other way, crosses it over, and gives it out. She's fouled. Big, big crowd on hand here tonight. It will be big several times before this one is, several times before this season is over. Several big games coming up. We'll have them right here on 99.5 The Fan. Want to give a shout out to the Pace Florida crew watching tonight down in Florida for Mickey Buchanan and the Lady Mustangs. Good to hear from you all. Claire Johnson with 18 seconds left. Lady Mustangs up 37-19. Johnson with a right-hand dribble goes to Hughes. Back to Johnson. Down to 5 seconds. Claire, does she know that? Down to 3 seconds. Left side three, no good. And that will do it for a really ugly quarter for both sides. A final score of 5-4 that quarter. But the Lady Mustangs maintain a lead, 37-19. And, Jimmy, the thing about that quarter is it's now over. Both teams can put it behind them and move to the fourth.
It is, but Coach Sivils has got to be frustrated with his squad. You know, we said at halftime, just come out here and continue to do what you did in that first half, and the Lady Mustangs did not. Graves County didn't do a whole lot better offensively for certain, and that's based on the Mustangs' defense. But I think where Coach Sivils has got to be frustrated, this half-court offense, we talked about good half-court offense execution as another one of the halftime adjustments, and to be honest, Eric, we've not seen it out of either team, but in particular the Lady Mustangs, they just seem to have went stagnant down in their half-court offense. And as you mentioned on air earlier, Coach Sivils was on them about moving. It just seemed like they set up outside the perimeter and were staying where they were, and there wasn't any Lady Mustangs getting open and not getting any open shots. So overall, I'm sure Coach Sivils has given them a pretty good speech here at the break between the quarters to kick it in gear. In his fourth quarter, I'd like to see the Lady Mustangs put up some points. Like I said, Eric, just to get to their normal season average of 61 points, they're going to have to score 24 points in this fourth quarter.
Want to give a shout-out to longtime family friend of mine, someone I adore greatly, Miss Kay Holland, listening in tonight. Also, Mean Gene Holland listening as well, and Cameron Rogers as well. Good to hear from you all on the Cellular Connection text hotline as they're watching tonight saying, go Mustangs. It is Lady Eagles basketball is a right side jump shot, no good. Clisson, a little turnaround rebound, no good. Rebound back to McCracken County as Hill in the backcourt gives it into the front court to Claire Johnson. Claire, crossover dribble into the lane, all the way to the rim, puts it up, no good, but she's fouled.
Eric, that was a much better start. There was a good defensive rebound by Reagan Hill there. She came down with that rebound, was able to get it out to Claire Johnson about half court, and Claire was able to drive it in there, should have made that layup. Was a pretty tough shot. I got to give Claire credit there. She had a defender on her, so now she's got two free throws.
As it is a free throw from Johnson that's no good. One more for Claire. Want to give a shout-out to Brandon Alexander listening in tonight. Also, as the second free throw from Claire good, she makes one of two. Matt Namberly Hauser listening as they drive to Lexington to support McCracken Wrestling. Good to hear from you all.
And 7:30 left in this fourth quarter, 38-19. As a running jumper, no good. Rebound is fought for. Graves County comes away with it. Put back up, no good. Rebound out of bounds off McCracken County. It'll stay with Graves County. And so overall, the Lady Mustangs up 38-19. They've doubled up the Lady Eagles. A wonderful first half from McCracken County. Neither team really playing well in that third quarter. As 9 total points in the third. And the Lady Mustangs playing defense in a 2-3 zone. Lady Eagles trying to work it around that zone. Is it Shea at the foul line? Now on the right side to Glisson. Short corner it goes. That is to Shea. Graves County patient here. They don't have a whole lot of time to be patient, down 19. To Alexander. And now into the lane, a floater up by Burgess, no good. Rebound comes down to Johnson. She races the other way from McCracken County. Claire into the lane, takes contact, puts it up, no good, but she's fouled. So Johnson will go shoot two. And so that will be, I think, 2 free throws.
Yeah, it will be, Eric. She was in the act of shooting there when she got bumped.
And Ava Hughes is in tears. Didn't see what happened to Ava, but she is in some pain, and so she will head to the sideline and meet trainer Aaron Swain. I did not see what happened. And so Claire will shoot two. First free throw from Claire is good. One more for Johnson, trying to extend this McCracken lead to 21. As it is no good, a rare 1-1 for Claire Johnson on back-to-back trips. As it will be Graves County with the basketball. On the right-hand side to Alexander, straight away to Glisson, back to Alexander. Using her right-hand dribble, and a timeout for Graves County with 6:26 in this fourth quarter. If you're just joining us, McCracken is up 39-19, led from the tip, jumped out to a 19-4 lead. And it's kind of just been an ugly second half, if you want to characterize it. 5-4 third quarter, and right now in the fourth quarter, a minute and a half into it, it's 2-0 McCracken County. So entire second half, it's a 6-5 McCracken advantage.
Yeah, Eric, I'll be honest with you. I can't say that, you know, I've seen that all season long from the Lady Mustangs. I mean, they're always knocking down 15 or 20 points a quarter. So, you know, for Coach Sibbles, he's got to be a little bit frustrated right now. I mean, the difference in this game is the first quarter. The Lady Mustangs put all those points up on the first quarter and got that big lead. I think it was 19-4 there in the first quarter, and that really is the difference basically in this game. So, you know, for Graves County, they've got to feel good about one thing. As I mentioned, Eric, they've come out in this second half and played even up with the Lady Mustangs, and that's not anything that you or I expected in calling this game, and I'm sure Coach Sibbles and his staff are not happy with Graves County playing even up with the Lady Mustangs in the second half.
So the Lady Mustangs up 39-19 with 6.5 minutes left in this game. As a free throw line jump shot off, no good. Rebound back to Graves County as Winfrey gives it off left side to Alexander. Her three is good. First three for Alexander. And that makes it 39-22. Lady Mustangs on top. As Johnson to Buchanan. As she turns, she'll stop. Her mid-range jump shot's good.
Mickey made that off the glass there, put it right in the box on the glass for a nice bank shot there.
41-22, Lady Mustangs on top. 5:48 left in the game. As it is Graves County the possession. Burgess into the corner, she throws it away. Back to McCracken County, another turnover for Graves County. To the Lady Mustangs, boys game to follow this one. And right now, it is Lady Mustangs in control, trying to close it out. 41-22, 5.5 minutes left. Buchanan using a dribble to Johnson. Claire into the lane. She floats one up, no good, but she's fouled.
Claire continues to drive the ball inside against the Lady Eagles, and they're fouling Claire. And we know this season Claire's one of the top free throw shooters on this team, even though I think, Eric, so far in the second half, She's went 2 for 4. Normally, Claire's a solid 4 out of 5 from the free throw line.
First one from Johnson is good. One more for Claire. Second free throw is good. Claire makes 2 of 2, 43-22. Graves County facing three-quarter court pressure and nearly a steal by Bowling. Graves County able to keep it as Alexandra into the front court, goes right side to Burgess. Her three, no good. Rebound comes down to Graves County as Alexandra another chance. 5 minutes left in the game, 43-22. Burgess, a three on the corner now. That one's good. That's Kinsey's third three, 43-25. 4:48 left in the game. Johnson to Buchanan. And down low to Bowen. Her five-footer's an air ball. Comes down to Hill. Now out to Skaggs. Her three. It's good.
There's a Jaden Skaggs we know well, Eric. You can count on Jaden Skaggs to get 2 or 3 three-pointers every game, and that's the first one we've seen this week as Jaden Skaggs was off the floor on Tuesday, but nice shot there.
I say uh-oh because Coach Scott Sybils just took off his glasses, and anytime he takes off his glasses, you just may want to pray because the team's about to get it. He is getting into it with his Lady Mustangs right now. And not happy at all with this second half from the Lady Mustangs. If he takes off the glasses, he means business. That's the first time this year I've watched him take off the glasses. And anytime that happens again, I just go into a moment of prayer.
Well, Eric, I think it's a good thing. These girls could probably use a little prayer because I've got to agree with you. For the fans at home, Coach Sybils was letting them have it.
Yes,
I think
he
they've
was.
Had a good discussion here. They got 4 minutes and 33 seconds left on the clock, and he expects some good performance out of these last 4 minutes.
46-25. We'll see what that did as Graves County the possession as it is going to be on the wing to Alexander. Her three is no good. Rebound is out of bounds off Jaden Skaggs. It will go back to Graves County.
Eric, that was another time Jaden Skaggs had good position there. She's done a great job. I mentioned that in the first half. Jaden's doing a good job rebounding. She had position there, just wasn't able to hold on to the ball.
Graves County to inbound to Burgess. Out top. Now swung on the left side to Alexander. Alexander using her dribble. Goes on the left-hand side to Scott. To Burgess. No, I'm sorry, to Glisten, excuse me. Now to Burgess. To Alexander in the corner. Graves County does not have much time to waste, but they are taking their time. As Burgess... on the right-hand side, she'll take a 15-footer. No good. Rebound back to Graves County. And another chance as it goes now into the lane. Poked away by McCracken County and stolen. And then a foul by the Lady Eagles as an inadvertent push. And it will be the fourth team foul for Graves County.
That was a good play by Reagan Hill there, Eric. She did a nice job. They tried to pass it inside there. Overall, trying to get the ball inside to Scott. And Reagan Hill wasn't having any of it. She tipped that ball back out to Lazaria Bolin, who came down with it. And like you said, she just got pushed and knocked down for a foul. But nice defensive play by Reagan Hill.
3:30 left in the game. 46-25 McCracken County as it goes to Skaggs in the corner. Her three's off the side of the backboard. No good. Graves County on the return. As Lady Eagles with it. Ella Kemp. In front of half court, goes on the left-hand side to Martin. As Martin, by her defender, now into the corner. To Alexander, at the foul line, poked away for a moment, recovered by Graves County before it's tied up. That will go back to McCracken County. 3:01 left.
Eric, I got to give a shout-out again to Reagan Hill. That was another defensive play by Reagan Hill. They tried to get the ball a second time in the paint. Reagan Hill was able to deflect that and end up getting that tied-up ball there, so McCracken County gets a possession.
Lady Mustangs possession, 3 minutes left. As it is going to be Reagan Hill. Now to Bolin, straight away to Skaggs. Now right side to Johnson. Short corner to Buchanan. As Mickey puts down a dribble, back to Johnson, straight away to Bolin. 2:40 left. Short corner to Buchanan. Out top Johnson. She pump fakes, uses her dribble. Crosses it over into the lane. And... lost it out of bounds, but it's off Graves County. Want to give a shout-out to Tammy and Kindred Pascal watching at home on the live feed. Going to hear from you all as they're relaxing for Tammy and Kindred Pascal on the Sailor Connection text hotline as it comes out to Buchanan, now to Johnson. She'll fire left side three. It's no good. Rebound comes out long, though. Skaggs able to chase it down to Buchanan. She thought about the three. She'll take the three. That's no good. Rebound is saved inbounds and recovered by Graves County. 2:10 left and a reach-in foul on McCracken County.
Eric, that was another ugly sequence there. I mean, granted, Claire took a nice three-pointer and so did Mickey Buchanan, but overall just a sequence down there offensively was just not, it just doesn't seem to be smooth or function at all for the Lady Mustangs down here on the offensive end. So unfortunate turnover there without getting an opportunity to score.
Haven't been many ugly halves for the Lady Mustangs this year, and so the competition for what I'm about to say is quite low, as a running jumper up and in by Ella Kemp, but could be the ugliest half of the season for the Lady Mustangs overall. There have not been many, so that's why the qualification is not huge, because the Lady Mustangs have just been nearly flawless this season. But Graves County has not played well, and McCracken has not played well this second half. As Buchanan straight away, 46-27 though, Lady Mustangs, that's the thing you love. You're playing a regional opponent, not playing well, you're still up 19.
Yeah, you are.
As it goes left side to Skaggs to Johnson. Minute 20 left. Back out to Buchanan. As Mickey picks up her dribble. Nope, I'm sorry, now hands it off to Johnson. Crosses it over. Down to a minute five. Straight away to Buchanan. As Mickey gives it off to Johnson. She's cutting in, brings it back out to Mickey. 55 seconds left. On the wing to Lazario. To Buchanan. Left side to Skaggs. Back to Buchanan. Back to Skaggs. 45 seconds. Down to 40 seconds. To Bowen. To Johnson. Down to 30 seconds.
I think Coach Sybil's there just wants to run out the clock and get to the locker room after this half.
I think you're right. Buchanan to Johnson to Hill. Oh, she'll take a jump shot, but it's short. Rebound comes back to Graves County. As the Lady Eagles the possession and throw it away. 11 seconds left.
Eric, so, I got to agree with you. I can say both boys and girls basketball games this year total that you and I've had the privilege of calling, this has been the ugliest half right here.
Yes. The composite score this second half, McCracken leads 9-8 as this game comes to an end tonight. Lady Mustangs win it 46-27. Overall, it was from the moment this game started, my friend, Lady Mustangs were able to jump out and set the pace and get the runaway win tonight.
Yeah, Eric, you know, we've got to give credit where credit's due. I mean, let's back up and look at that first half. The Lady Mustangs, as we talked about at halftime, they played flawless in that first half. Claire had a great half, put up 20 points there in that first and second quarter. And overall, the Lady Mustangs were playing that same defense that we've seen all season long. But I don't know if it was just a big lead at halftime. Got to give a little bit of credit to Graves County. I mean, walking out of here tonight, if they could go home and say, hey, we held the Lady Mustangs to just 9 points and a half, man, they think that's a win all the way. And for the Lady Mustangs, only outscoring them 9-8 in the whole half is a little bit something I'm sure Coach Sybils was frustrated about. You called it out that he was giving the girls a pretty good talking to there with about 4 minutes left in his quarter. I think he's frustrated. I'm sure when he goes back and they practice this week getting ready for the next game, this is going to be a point that Coach Sybils is going to be upset about, that the Lady Mustangs only scored 9 points and a half. I mean, one of the things is, Eric, you got to look at, if you were in district play, regional play, or you were over in Lexington and you only scored 9 points and a half, 9 out of 10 times you're not going home the victor. Fortunate for the Lady Mustangs, they had a great first half.
And that's what you look at if you're McCracken County. You did not play well, but you still dominated a regional opponent with things you can still improve on. That's the great news if you're McCracken County.
Yeah, Eric, I think this, I mean, to me, when I look at this game overall, you could get probably 6-7 minutes into that first quarter, and I don't think the game was ever in question after that point in time. I mean, as I said, the Mustangs were out at 19-4 at one point there in the first quarter, and when you're out that far leading, and you could just tell Graves County did not do good from the floor. I talked a little bit about it in pregame. They don't have a good shooting percentage from the floor. I think the defense of the Mustangs just made it that much more difficult. I mean, we talk about their leading scorer, Hannah Glisson. I don't think she scored a basket from the floor until the second half. So that's just that great, great defense that the Mustangs have. And, you know, one of the other things is, Eric, we've commented a little bit about the Lady Mustangs only scoring 9 points in this second half. But I think one of the things is that we've got to take a highlight out of this game is not only did they only score 9 points, but their defense continued to hold Graves County down to just 8 points in that second half. So even though they didn't have a good offensive second half, they played the same good defense in the second half.
And so it is a little bit of reverb we had here in the gym. Mercy. Goodness gracious. And so that will ruin the hearing of everyone in the gym. So we will look at the final scoring for tonight. And with that, Jimmy Garrett.
So we'll take a look at Graves County first. Ella Kemp, she ended up with 2 points. Kinsey Burgess, who had 1, 2, 3 three-pointers in this game, she ended up with a total of 9 points overall. Sydney Shea, who was the leading scorer in the first half with 5. She didn't score in the second half. She ended up with a total of 5 points for the game. Hannah Glisson, who we talked about, didn't have any shots from the floor until the second half. She had 2 in the second half. So a total tonight for the leading scorer for Graves County, Hannah Glisson, who scores about 14 a game. The Lady Mustangs defense did a good job, held her down to 6 total points. Morgan Alexander, the second leading scorer for Graves County, we were able to hold her down to just 3 points, a three-pointer there late in the fourth quarter. And then Kaylee Winford was the other scorer tonight for Graves County. She had a total of 2. Taking a look at the Lady Mustangs tonight, overall, Claire Johnson had a great game. She had 20 in that first half, as I mentioned. Only 4 in the second half. All those came from the free throw line. Claire ended up with a total of 24 points. Jaden Skaggs had a good game. She had a total of 4. Reagan Hill had an excellent game. We talked about the contributions of Reagan Hill. She had a total of 8 tonight. And then the only other scorer tonight for the Lady Mustangs, Mickey Buchanan, she had a total of 10, 8 in the first half, 2 in the second half. So overall, when you look at it, Eric, I think that is one thing that's probably a little concerning for Coach Sybils is he only had 4 Mustangs score tonight overall in this ball game. That's probably the lowest number of scores we've seen from the Lady Mustangs all season.
And so the Lady Mustangs get the win tonight. Final score 46-27. When we come back, actually we'll keep it right here in just a moment, actually about 20 minutes, we'll have the boys contest tonight between McCracken County and Graves County. That will be coming up in just a little bit here on 99.5 The Fan, as we will have that coverage for you. And it's on the McCracken Media YouTube channel as well, if you want to watch it tonight via YouTube. When we come back, actually, we will chat with the head coach of the Lady Mustangs, Coach Scott Sybils. Give our final thoughts on this matchup. Turn to the boys game when we return. 99.5 The Fan.
We understand that life happens, and sometimes you need a little financial boost. That's why at C-Plant Federal Credit Union, we offer low-rate loans tailored to your needs. Whether it's a car loan, a personal loan, or anything in between, we've got you covered. Learn more at cplant.com or visit any of C-Plant Federal Credit Union's 9 local branches. Member NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
There is a lot of confusion surrounding the Employee Retention Tax Credits, or the ERTC. Many have said that the program has been stopped or shut down, but that is just not true. CS Business Consulting has personally consulted and advised with the IRS that they are still accepting applications and time is running out. CS Business Consulting in Paducah, Kentucky has filed for over $135 million in credits for their customers. Contact us today to find out if you are eligible and qualified to file for these credits.
Learn more at CSBIZCON.com.
I had top Strawberry Hills Pharmacy Arena on the campus of McCracken County High School. The Lady Mustangs victorious tonight. Final score,
46-27. The Lady Mustangs win. They now go to the Lady Mustangs to face Delta, Missouri tomorrow. That is at 2:30 right here on 99.5 The Fan. Joining now is the head coach of the Lady Mustangs, Coach Scott Sivels. As coach, overall, a win is a win. Great first quarter. Kind of a just tough it out from that point on,
sure.
But a win is a win.
We just, probably the one negative thing, we give up too many second chance points. I thought our defense was excellent tonight. Went for four quarters. We didn't allow them easy shots. But I'd say second half, I would say almost all their points were just off second chance points from our rebounding. But overall, we just did just enough offensively. We did just enough just to get the win. Love the effort tonight. My goodness, kids played their butts off. And what's good about this, Jimmy, is we can get better.
Yeah, you know, when we look at it overall, you know, as Eric mentioned, he held them to 17 points in the first half. That was that great defense that we had all season long, particularly in that first quarter. You know, in that first quarter, we held them to just 4 points and then held them to 8 points total in that second quarter. So, you know, one of the things is we talked all evening long, coaches, about the defense. The defensive side of this ball team, one of the things, as I said pregame, was the defense is really what leads to success on the offense. And tonight, you've held a pretty good team out of Graves County, Region 1 team, to just 25 points. So the defense had an excellent night. Let's talk a little bit about the offense. You know, that first quarter in particular, man, that offense was clicking. Claire had a great first half. She put up 20 points. But talk a little bit about the offense in the second half. It looked like a little bit of back and forth.
Stagnant.
Just not as clean cut as we normally see out of Lady Mustangs.
Watching too much. We had a couple of timeouts there just to kind of – I just don't know, just emphasizing, we got to move better offensively. We stood and watched too much. We just got stagnant for some reason. It's kind of hard to explain, but it happens sometimes when a team throws you a certain zone. We just didn't react like we should have. We just stood, and that happens. And we missed some shots. I thought Reagan Hill played a terrific game tonight offensively. She got the ball certain times and scored for us. Very impressed by her. She has to give us that kind of effort every night going forward from here on out this year and give us that third score. I thought Jaden Skaggs played well at times tonight. Made a big three there in the second half. But again, we just got to get other kids going offensively. And but let's be honest, this is the first time our young kids have seen a crowd like this. And let's be honest, sometimes it kind of can be sometimes bigger than them, and they're not kind of ready for that. And I thought our seniors did an excellent job of kind of leading the way tonight, both offensively and defensively. But again, I like how Laser and Ava play defense up front. We emphasize not letting them be comfortable. They weren't comfortable tonight offensively. We made them earn every single point tonight on their offensive end. So I'm very pleased with that. But again, a win's a win in this region. We can get better from this game. We can come back tomorrow against a really good Delta Missouri team who's undefeated, I think. So looking forward to that matchup tomorrow.
So let's talk a little bit about rebounding. We talked a little bit about it a moment ago. You know, in that first half, really the Lady Mustangs had their way both offensively and defensively from a rebounding standpoint. It did slough off a little bit there in the second half. But, you know, a couple people, Eric and I talked about on air, Reagan Hill had a good night rebounding, mm-hmm. Mickey Buchanan. But one standout, one of the things is Coach Sivels that I mentioned, Jaden Skaggs had a good job rebounding, particularly in that first half. She did a great job rebounding.
Yes, she did.
And that's not normal for Jaden Skaggs to bring down five or six rebounds, but she had a great first half. What do you think the difference was rebounding-wise from that first half to second half?
We watched too much second half. I think in the second half, we didn't do a very good job of reacting fast enough and getting the – I mean, we were in position. We just kind of watched and let things happen. We emphasize you got to box out, then go get the ball. I mean, And, of course, they were being very physical. Could have been more fouls called. Sure, they could. But I just told our kids in a couple of timeouts, we've got to be tougher down in the trenches down there and go up and get some of those tough rebounds. And second half, we didn't. Now, when it counted, we got those that we had to have. But credit them. They played hard the whole game. Overall, just pleased with the outcome. Well, the mistakes we made tonight, Jimmy, are very, very correctable. So we'll watch the film, and we'll get better from this. We'll get better offensively. We'll get better, more flow in our offense against the zone. That's the thing that we're going to see going forward is a lot of zone, a lot of mix-up zone, 3-2, 2-3, boxing one, triangle and two. They'll play a man-to-man, played off. Teams are going to have to play us differently just because of who we are and what Claire can bring to the table along with Mickey. So, I love how our kids responded. It's homecoming. There's so much going on. The dance is tomorrow night. So there's so much going on that these high school kids are involved with. So I love how the kids were involved in the game, ready to play.
Yeah. So let's talk a little bit about tomorrow afternoon. Tomorrow we got another game, like you said, a Delta Missouri team that you think is coming in here undefeated.
I think so.
So you got a pretty good opponent tomorrow. So kind of what's the preparation after tonight's game in preparation tomorrow night for Delta Missouri?
Same thing. We're playing tomorrow at 2:30. We've had to scramble to find film on them. We found some film early on in December, and we found a tape this week and sometime in the middle of January. So they're a team that's kind of like Graves County. They're very scrappy. They're going to probably press more and try to cause havoc on the front end. And then if we break the press, they'll come from behind and try to, dig and punch and grab and scratch. And they'll play five out and shoot the threes everywhere. So we'll see. They've, like us, the last two or three years have been very successful in 1A in Missouri. They've got terrific players. So, but again, Missouri is a little bit different than Kentucky. I don't know how tough their area is, where they're from, but I do know that they are a very formidable team that we're going to play tomorrow afternoon, so it'd be a good matchup for us.
Coach, congratulations on a win tonight as the Lady Mustangs able to get the win. And now you've got, of course, Delta Center, as you talked about, and then into next week, into next weekend, and then the stretch run is here.
Yes, baby.
It feels like tonight was kind of another kickoff to another nice run of first region opponents coming up.
Yes, and we're gonna see Graves here in a couple of weeks. We got Marshall still left. We've got Callaway still left. We have a very good Davis County team coming in the next day after the Graves game. So we've got some. I'm trying to find one more home game. It's very, very tough, boys, trying to find a home game.
Sure.
It's very, very tough. I've been scratching and clawing trying to find one home game. So, but, yes, we have some games coming down the stretch that we can win. But, our goal right now, I'm telling Jimmy, we got to get better going forward and make some corrections on a few things and be ready to go. But, hey. I'm very proud of our girls and our coaching staff, and they work so hard, and we'll come back tomorrow ready to play.
That's all you can do. And
yes,
we will have that for you right here as the Lady Mustangs in Delta, Missouri tomorrow afternoon, at 2:30 here on 99.5 The Fan. Coach, appreciate it as always, my friend. Go enjoy some basketball here tonight.
Thank you, fellas. Go Mustangs.
All right.
Appreciate
it. The head coach of the Lady Mustangs, Coach Scott Civils. As his Lady Mustangs victorious tonight, 46-27, the final score here this evening. Let's look ahead now. Close the book on the girls' game. Look ahead to the boys' game tonight. McCracken County and Graves County getting set to square off here in just a little bit. As we jump in, let's look at the teams overall coming into the matchup. And once again with that, Jimmy Garrett.
So let's take a look at Graves County. They're coming into tonight's matchup, Eric, 15-5. So basically the same record as the Mustangs have. So two teams here evenly matched up. When you look overall at their schedule, looking down at their schedule, they're coming off a loss. They lost on January 23rd to Callaway County. They lost 54-66. Before that, they had a three-game winning streak there against some teams out of state and also Hickman County. So, you know, they faced up against a tough team. We played Callaway County a few weeks ago down at Callaway County. We took a loss there as well, basically by about the same difference as the Graves County Eagles did the other night against Callaway County. Taking a look a little bit at them season-wise so far overall, looking at this Eagles team right now, they're shooting 48% from the field. So a little bit lower, but not much lower than the Mustangs overall shooting from the field. From the three-point area, they're doing pretty good. As a team, Eric, they're 35.6% outside the arc. We'll look at it. They've got three shooters that are doing a good job outside the arc. And then looking at it from a free throw situation, they're only averaging 67% out on the free throw line. So pretty balanced scoring overall for the Eagles. When we take a look at it individually, they've got three players in double digits right now, low double digits, but nonetheless double digits. They got Lucas Pig, who's averaging 13.2, a Briley Bukasevic, he's averaging 11.3, and then you got Braden Waller, he's coming in at 11.2 as well. So three players in the double digits, but fairly low from a scoring standpoint. Taking a look at how well they're doing shooting from the field, who's the leaders on this team right now? And when you look at it, Braden Waller, he's the leader right now. He's shooting 58% from the field overall. Lucas Pig, who's the leading scorer, he's at 50.9. And then Briley Kasevic, who I just mentioned, he's at about 48% overall from the field. So pretty balanced between those three leading scorers. And then when you take a look at overall for the Eagles, where they're getting that three-point production at is really three areas. One of them is Carson Carrico. He right now, he's 16 for 37. He's averaging nearly 44% outside the arc. Lucas Pig being the second best shooter they've got outside the arc, he's averaging 37.3. And then Briley Bukasevic, he right now is at 33.8. So they've got three shooters that are on the court on a regular basis that are above 33%. And like I said, a Carson Carrico there, he's clear up at almost 44%. So pretty good shooter from outside. Taking a little look at them from a free throw standpoint, like I said, as a team, they're at 67%. These guys that are starting, when you look at them overall, Bukasevic, he's at about 64. Waller's at 64. A Lucas Pig is at 65. So one of the things is I think is a little bit interesting overall is when you look at their free throw shooters that are starting, Eric, they're below 70%. So a little bit of a struggle area. So it'll be interesting to see if that plays any part in the game overall tonight. Here's one area, Eric, that they're really down. When I looked at the stats overall for this team, that they're really down on, and that is from the rebounding standpoint. When you look at it from a rebounding standpoint, they're only averaging 19 rebounds a game. I'll tell you what, Eric, that's a low number. We don't see that low a number in girls basketball or boys basketball. So it'll be interesting to see how that plays out. Who's the leading rebounders on this team right now? A Braden Waller, he's at 6'6". A Briley Bukasevic, he's at 4.4. And then Carricchio right there, he's at 2.7. So overall, this is when you look at it statistically, this is a fairly poor team from a rebounding standpoint. But you got to look at their record. They're 15-5, so maybe they're making it up offensively on a little bit higher shooting percentage outside the arc. So that's kind of a summary look at this team. I think, Eric, overall defensively tonight, I think the Mustangs are going to have to make sure that they put a lot of pressure on a Waller, Pig, and Bukasevic out there on the three-point perimeter. I think that's where they're going to want to go for their points.
And overall, McCracken County's numbers coming into this one overall as they are getting to take on the Graves County Eagles. Overall, they have been pretty good. It's been a mixed week, 1-1 week, as they won at St. Mary on Tuesday. They lost at UHA on Monday. But overall, it's been a pretty good season for the Mustangs so far. 15-5 overall. Let's take a look at some of their numbers.
So taking a look overall at the field, the Mustangs are basically the same as I just mentioned with Graves County. I've mentioned Graves County's at 48.8 from the field. McCracken County's at 48.2. Jumping down and looking at it from a three-point standpoint, the Mustangs are shooting 33.6% compared to 35.6. So a little better hand there for Graves County overall. From the free throw line, like I said, overall as a team, when you look at the team's stat, it's 62.4. But in the moment here, we'll get into the starters and the main free throw shooters on this team, and that percentage has come up considerably. Taking a look at the leading scorers right now for the Mustangs, Connor Miller, who we know every game does all he can to put points up for the Mustangs. He's at 18.3 points per game. And then Jackson Klope is right there with him at 16.3 points per game. Some of these other guys have grown and continue to contribute for the team, and we've seen their averages come up. Dylan Jackson, who's had some double-digit games this month, right now he's at 8.7, so he's contributing as the third leading scorer. Caden Fulcher coming off the bench. Interesting enough, Eric, the fourth leading scorer on this team is Caden Fulcher. He's coming off the bench. He's averaging 5.5 points a game. Jay Martin, who's starting at that point guard position, he's averaging 4.5 points per game. And then Grayson Parrish, who continues to contribute as well. He's above 4 points now. He's averaging 4.3. So those are your top five or six scorers so far for the Mustangs this season. Taking a look at where we're at shooting percentage for some of these starters. So you drop down through there. Jackson Klope is leading the way. Well, I want to back up and just mention one thing, Eric, before I get into Jackson Klope. A couple other guys I think need to be mentioned. Jackson Diaz, who's been playing some this month in January, he's been having a good month. He's shooting at 66.7 from the field. And Owen Grogan, who we talked about, had a good game Tuesday night against St. Mary's. He's shooting at 61% from the field. From the starter standpoint, Jackson Klope's leading the way. He's shooting 61% from the field. And then it drops down a little bit. It drops down a little bit. Overall, you drop down to Connor Miller. He's shooting at 46%. Dylan Jackson's at 46%. Caden Fulcher's at 45%. And then Grayson Parrish is right at 40% from the field. When we look at them from a three-point shooting standpoint, where are we at overall this season? Jay Martin, who is having an excellent season. Jay Martin right now, he's shooting at 38.2%. Coming into the game Tuesday night, he was actually up at 40%. So right now he dropped down a little bit to 38.2%. Owen Grogan, who's been coming off the bench some, only 8 attempts, but he's shooting 37.5%. Caden Fulcher, he's another guy that continues to step up. He's up to 37% now. He's 17 out of 46. The leading shooter from outside the arc right now, you got Connor Miller. He's taken 82 attempts so far outside the arc. He's made 28, so he's at 34.1. And then you've got Jackson Klope, who Coach Roberts tells you and I both, he wants him shooting three-pointers. You know, so he's been out there shooting three-pointers. Right now, Jackson's at 26.3, so he's 5 of 19. He's doing a good job for the big man shooting outside the arc. Taking a look at it from free throws, like I said, team-wise, it looks a little low at 62.4, but when you dig into it, it looks a whole lot better. Jay Martin, the starting point guard, he's at 76.5% from the free throw line. Connor Miller continues to prove there. He's at 72.2, and then it drops down a little bit. Dylan Jackson's had a little bit of a tough time. We know he's a good shooter outside the arc, but he's struggled a little bit from the free throw line. He's right at 60%. And then Jackson Klope, who he's getting better and better. I think one of the things is right now he's almost up to 50%. He's one shot short of being at the 50% mark. That's a climb for Jackson Klope. One of the things is, Eric, I like is he made those two key free throws down the line with 18 seconds on the clock and a two-point lead. You know, that's a tight spot to be in. Jackson sank both those free throws, so we know that he can make them. I think the last stat to look at for the Mustangs, Eric, that we've got to continue to brag on Jackson Klope. He's a double-digit rebounder. So, you know, I just mentioned that overall as a team, Graves County's averaging 19 rebounds a game. Well, Jackson Klope by himself is averaging almost 11. So you got a great rebounder in Jackson Klope. And then you drop down and you take Connor Miller at 5.6, and you got Grayson Parrish at 3.5. So you combine those three starters inside, and those guys just alone, just those three guys, are averaging 20 rebounds a game. What are the Mustangs averaging overall as a team? They're averaging 29.8, so we'll just round it to 30 rebounds per game. Some other guys that have done a good job rebounding so far this year, I want to give some credit to Dylan Jackson's been in there pulling down rebounds. When Jackson Diaz and Owen Grogan's in there, they've been pulling down some rebounds. And one of the guys that you and I talk about regularly, Eric, is Caden Fulcher. When he gets in the game, even though he's maybe 5'9", 5'10", he just seems to be able to get in the right position to get a lot of rebounds. So, you know, one of the things is you got to look at tonight coming into this game, Eric, the Mustangs have a 10 rebound per game plus over Graves County.
That's right. And that is a number that McCracken County may try to exploit. And for McCracken County, looking at this, Brandon Clifton, Allstate Insurance for success for the Mustangs. Defense on the perimeter.
Yeah, Eric, I just talked about this team is a good shooting team from outside the perimeter. I mean, they've got three guys that are averaging better than 33% and one guy averaging nearly 44% outside the arc. So I think one of the things that we don't want to see happen tonight, we experienced it a couple weeks ago over at Callaway County. They had some good shooters on the court, and they exploited that. They took advantage of the Mustang defense. They got a lot of open shots. They have made a high percentage of those, 80% of them in the first quarter down there at Callaway County. So I think tonight one of the things is I want to see out of this Mustang defense is a lot of pressure on those shooters out on the arc.
Also for McCracken County tonight, playing a full game from start to finish.
Yeah, Eric, and I think that's something Coach Roberts has talked to you and I about. He's frustrated with his team there. He can't get the full 32 minutes of play out of them. I know he's frustrated. He's talked to us after game. He's talked to us on Wednesday evenings that he just can't seem to get this team mentally to play all 32 minutes. And I think the best example of that, and really is these last two games, the one game against Tillman in particular, when you look at the scoreboard at the end, it's like, hey, Mustangs kind of pushed past Tillman. That wasn't the case. For 3.5 quarters, they dominated that game. And then all of a sudden, in a 3 or 4 minute stretch, they allowed them to climb back in that game. St. Mary's was the same way. They didn't seem to play hard in the first half. And then the second half, they did a great job to come out with that victory. So I think tonight, Eric, in a close game, you got to play all 32 minutes.
That's right. As that is your Brandon Clifton Allstate Insurance for success. You're always in good hands with McCracken County Allstate agent Brandon Clifton in Paducah. It's about time for our starting lineups tonight. As a near capacity crowd on hand, especially for McCracken County. As McCracken came out in full force tonight, not a bad crowd tonight here for Graves County as well. Not as many as I've seen in past years when Graves comes, but not bad either. And so McCracken County and Graves County about to be introduced. Let's go down to the public address voice of Strawberry Hills Pharmacy Arena and Mr. Daryl Good.
Freshman number 11, Maria Nicholas.
for tip here tonight. As a tip goes in the air, it's controlled by Graves County. The Mustangs start out. It looks like in man-to-man offense is out top. It is Mathis. It goes on the left-hand side to Pig. Lucas Pig goes now down on to the low block to Bradley Vukasevic. He brings it back towards the perimeter, back to Pig. Now comes on the near side, on the far side to Holland. Straight away back to Vukasevic, swung to Mathis, now left side to Pig. Using a crossover dribble, thought about a three, goes back out top to Holland. Swung on the wing now to Mathis. As Mathis brings it out top to Pig, swung left side to Vukasevic. He thought about a baseline drive, brought it back now onto the mid block to Braden Waller. He takes a baseline drive, and that is a block. That was a 50-50 call, goes against McCracken County. And it will be Graves County underneath its own basket. And so the 50-50 call.
Eric, it looks like Dylan Jackson might have busted him a little bit there in the face, it looks like almost. Looks like they've got to take him out of the game. Not sure if he might be bleeding a little bit, so they're sending him over to see Aaron.
As it is going to be a pass knocked out of bounds off of McCracken County, it will stay with Graves County. And it will come in to Graves County. It is going to be Mathis as he gives it off now to Lucas Pink. Goes to Vukasevic as he hands it off now to Mathis. He stops, turns now, gives it out top to Vukasevic. Man-to-man defense continues for McCracken County. 1 minute in, Graves County the possession. As Mathis into the lane, spins, turns, looks, and now fires it back out. Graves County taking time, but Klump takes it away. Jackson all the way to the rim for the dunk. How about that? Welcome to McCracken County. Eagles meet Jackson Klump. Mercy. 2-0. Mustangs on top. As it is going to be out top, Bradley Vukasevic swings it on the left side to Lucas Pig. Pig crosses it over into the lane, stops, looks, gives it out top. A three coming from Mathis is good. Reagan Mathis answers, it's 3-2. Walking it up, it is going to be Jay Martin for the Mustangs to Klump. He hands it off to Fulcher. As Fulcher back to Martin, thought about the three, goes now to Klump, swings it left side to Miller. Miller gives it out to Martin. He'll take a spot up right side three and bury it. Jay Martin gives the Mustangs a lead. It's 5-3. 5:53 in this opening quarter. It is Lucas Pig who gives it off to Mathis. Mathis left-hand side of the floor to Vukasevic. Now on the floor to Waller. His floater in the lane. No good. Rebound, Connor Miller. He races the other way. Miller into the front court. Gives it right side. Fulcher right side. Three. No good. Rebound fought for. Controlled by Waller. 5-3 Mustangs, 5:30 in this opening quarter. You're going to see a contrast in styles. Graves County wants to go as slow as possible. The Mustangs want to go as fast as possible. Which style will win out tonight, slow or fast? That will likely be the winner of this game. The Eagles, they'd love it to be in the teens. As slow as they play can sometimes. Is going to be Waller. Takes his time. Hands it off left side to Mathis. Graves County changing their play. 5 minutes in this first quarter. Chain of defense from the Mustang students. Mathis, top of the key. Gives it off to Waller. Waller works towards a low baseline, receives contact, and he's fouled, and that's Jackson Klump. He's got his first. And so that will send Waller to the foul line to shoot two. So Braden Waller, the 6'5 junior forward. Goes to the foul line to shoot two. The first free throw from Waller is good. One more free throw coming for the junior, trying to tie it up at five. The second free throw for Waller is good. 5-5 game as Connor Miller will bring it up for McCracken County. As Miller goes on the wing to Klump. Down low to Miller. He turns on the baseline. His layup's good. Connor Miller finishes at the rim. Mustangs lead 7-5. Want to give a shout out to Will Sibbles listening in tonight. Good to hear from you, brother. One of our many Mustang alums we've heard from tonight. Always great to hear from Will. As it goes to Waller on the block, he turns, layup's good. Waller ties it up at 7, 4:15 in this first quarter. It will be Jay Martin bringing it up from McCracken County. Gives it off now to Miller. To Clope. As Clope straight away to Parrish. He'll take a 17-footer. No good. Rebound comes down to Graves County. Eagles on the return. It is going to be walked up by Lucas Pig. As Pig on the right-hand side. Goes to Waller straight away. Hands it off now out top to Vukasevic. As Vukasevic goes on the right-hand side. As it is Pig. He'll take a three. It's no good. Rebound comes down to Fulcher. Fulcher races the other way from McCracken County. As Fulcher stops. Now using his dribble. Gives it to Clope straight away. Down low it's to Parrish. Strong power dribble. Puts it up and in.
Well, that was a nice pass from Jackson Clope, but I got to give Grayson Parrish credit. He did a nice job getting his defender off his feet and getting that off the glass for a quick basket at the rim.
Mustangs on top 9-7, 3:15 in this opening quarter. Graves County the possession. As a crossover goes left side into the corner to Carrico. Now to Waller. His 17-footer's good. Braden Waller from 17 ties it up at 9. Jay Martin will walk it the other way. Martin. Into the front court for McCracken County. It's all the way to the rim, hands it off, and, he waved it off. It is an offensive foul against McCracken County. It looked like he may have gave the and one single, but it was in fact pointing the other way. And I was trying to decipher his, looked like he was trying to decide if it was and one or offensive foul, but it was offensive foul.
That's one of those 50-50 calls you mentioned earlier. It went against Dylan Jackson. That's two that have not went McCracken County's way.
And so it is going to be Graves County the possession as it is Carrico. As Carrico behind the back dribble, picks it up, turns, gives it back out to Lucas Pig. Mustangs and Eagles tied at 9. As Holland on the right side now goes straight away to Vukasevic. He stops, 15-footer is off. Rebound comes down to Jay Martin. Martin on the return gives it off to Fulcher. As Fulcher crosses it over a couple of times and sets up in the half court for McCracken County. 9-9 game, 2:15 in the opening quarter as Parrish on the right-hand side goes straight away to Clope. On the wing, it goes to Fulcher. Straight away to Miller. Thought about a spot up. Spins in the lane, turns, gives it off to Clope on the wing. Clope down low to Parrish. He turns in the lane, puts one up. No good, but he's fouled.
I like the play so far by Grayson Parrish. We've not seen him get that aggressive on the offensive end of the boards all season long, but Jackson Clope's feeding him in, and I've got to give Grayson Parrish credit. That's a toughness that we want to see out of him, and I'm sure Coach Roberts is happy with the play that he's seen out of Grayson Parrish so far in his first quarter.
No doubt about it. As Grayson is free throw. Is too strong and off. It's no good. One more coming for Grayson Parrish. Trying to give the Mustangs a one-point lead. As his free throw is good. He makes one of two. And the Mustangs lead right now 10-9. Just underway. With a minute 58 here in this opening quarter. As it will be for Graves County, Reagan Mathis in the backcourt. As Mathis picks up his dribble, now gives it up to Carrico. Back to Mathis. As he's into the front court, almost traveled with it. Goes down to Pig. Left side, a three coming from Carrico, no good. Rebound, fought for, controlled by Parrish. He gives it off to Jackson. A minute 37 in this opening quarter. Walking it up from McCracken County is Fulcher. Fulcher on the right-hand side of the floor. Crosses it over a couple of times, goes to Parrish. Hands it off to Jackson. He'll thought about a three. Now goes to Miller. He'll take the three and bury it. Connor Miller makes it 13-9. McCracken County, minute 10 in this first quarter. Graves County the possession. Carrico. Now Mathis looking to get it across. Mathis does now on the far right side. It goes into Carrico. His floater, no good. Rebound back to Waller. He goes up, no good, but he's fouled. And so Waller will go shoot two. For Graves County.
Eric, that looks like a foul on Grayson Parrish. I think that's just his first for the evening. You know, we want to make sure, we didn't talk too much about that in pregame, but we don't want to see Cloak, Parrish, or Connor Miller getting any foul trouble tonight in this tough matchup.
Waller's free throw is good. One more free throw coming for Waller. Checking in for McCracken County is going to be Owen Grogan. Is Dylan Jackson getting a breather? One more free throw coming for Braden Waller. And it's good. He makes 2 of 2. 4 of 4 today is Braden. And it's 13-11. Mustangs on top. 55 seconds in this first quarter. It's Jay Martin in the backcourt with Connor Miller. Back with Jay Martin. As Martin to Miller. Down to 44 seconds. Back to Martin. Swung to Fulcher. As Fulcher, he throws it away. Picked off on the play by Vukasevic. And Graves County will wait for the final shot. 30 seconds here in this first quarter. It is going to be Reagan Mathis. If you're just joining us, it is a contrast in styles. Graves County will play it slow. And I mean extra slow if they want. Goes back to the Alan Hatcher type basketball at times. McCracken County wants to run any chance they can. Down to 10 seconds. Comes straight away to Vukasevic. Down to 5 seconds to Mathis. Swung left side as it goes to Carrico. Back out to Vukasevic. And then it's nearly thrown away. That was a bad sequence for Graves County to end the first quarter. After one quarter of play, the Mustangs on top 13-11. And it's more of the pace Graves County wants at the moment, but credit to the Mustangs, able to lead after one at that pace.
Yeah, Eric, even though it's a little bit slower pace game, I like what the Mustangs have done so far. I mean, they've slowed down with Graves County, played half-court offense overall. They've been doing a good job in their half-court offense. They've taken a couple nice three-pointers. They've done a couple passes where Jackson Clope's got the ball inside to Grayson Parrish. So they're playing inside, outside. Connor Miller had a shot there at the rim as well. So overall, Eric, you got to give the Mustangs an A-plus on execution down here on the offensive end. Down on the defensive end, they've done a good job as well. One of the things is that I talked about in pregame is limiting the opportunities for Graves County outside the arc. And so far, this Mustang offense is, or defense has done a really good job limiting those opportunities out around the arc. I mean, overall, Eric, if it wasn't for Waller, I think Waller's probably got 6 points of the 11 points so far for Graves County. The Mustangs that have a little bit of better lead. So overall, we got to give Waller credit. He's doing a good job offensively for Graves County. And like you said, they've got a patient style of basketball about them overall, but so far the Mustangs have been able to match them on both ends of the court.
So the Mustangs right now on top after one quarter of a play, 13-11. It will be the Mustangs starting with the possession here in this second quarter. And it will be Cloak to inbound it to Jay Martin. We're underway here in the second. As Martin walks it into the front court, he goes to Cloak. Cloak hands it off to Miller, who gets a screen. Nice pick and roll, and his shot is no good, but he's fouled.
Looks like he said he's fouled on the floor there, Eric, so
all
I don't
right.
think he's going to get to go to the free throw line. The way the referee, the official called that, he was pointing to the floor. I'm assuming that's what he meant.
And the Mustangs will have it underneath their own basket. As it comes in to Connor Miller. Out top to Martin, swung to Cloak. Back to Martin. As Jay on the right-hand side. Directing traffic goes straight away to Cloak. As Jackson, left side to Fulcher. Back to Cloak straight away. Cloak puts the dribble down to Martin. He's going to think about a three. Goes instead to Grogan. Back to Martin. SJ goes to Cloak. Now to Grogan. Thought about the three. Goes on the wing to Fulcher. Gets by his defender. All the way to the rim. Layup's perfect.
Yeah, Eric, it was perfect. They left a wide open lane there for Caden Fulcher. He took advantage of that. That was a nice play because originally it looked like he wanted to shoot outside the arc, and he saw the open lane there and took advantage of it.
15-11, the Mustangs lead. As a backdoor cut, beautifully executed, shot no good. Rebound comes down to Cloak. Mustangs head the other way. As it goes left side to Grogan. He takes a spot up three, no good. Rebound back to Graves County.
I see my buddy Brian York over there. It looks quite demonstrative. I have a feeling he's not happy with the officiating at the moment. I see him pointing that finger quite a bit over there.
He wanted that call to go Graves County way, and it didn't. I'll be honest, that was a good no call.
As a left side three on the way, no good. Rebound goes over the backboard, and that will be a foul on the floor against McCracken County. Can't say enough. 9 in and 9 out, Region 1 officials, best in the region, best in the state. It is wonderful what these region officials do. 9 in and 9 out, thankful for them. As Graves County will inbound it. As it goes on the far right side of the floor, now to Mathis. Mustangs on top, 15 to 11. On the wing, it's to Vukasevic. Now swung on the right-hand side to Mathis. Mathis out top to Waller. Swung on the left-hand side to Pick. Straight away to Vukasevic. Swung on the wing to Waller. Out top to Vukasevic. Graves County taking their time here. 5:45 in this second quarter. Riley Vukasevic goes on the left-hand side to Waller. I'm sorry, to Mathis. Mathis down low to Waller, in between a double team, turns against Parrish. His right-hand floater, it rims out. Rebound comes down to Clope, and Clope will bring it up to Martin. Mustangs with the lead, 15-11, 5:25 in this second quarter. Jay Martin with it, goes on the left side to Clope. Clope straight away to Parrish, goes to Martin. Martin out top to Clope, back to Martin. As Martin resets the offense for the Mustangs. 5 minutes in the second quarter. Mustangs lead 15-11. Grayson Parrish back to Martin. Now out top to Grogan. He thought about a three to Clope. Down low, as an entry pass was not a good one. It goes, and that's a traveling violation. That will go against McCracken County. And it will be Connor Miller to check in. Parrish went to the deck, and with that goes some perspiration that they have to clean up a little bit.
Yeah, Eric, you know, that was a traveling call on Parrish. That was another 50-50 call. I mean, overall, Jackson Clope did a good job finding Parrish open in there, but really before the ball ever got to him, it looked like Grayson Parrish had been pushed there. But fortunately for Graves County, he caught that ball as he went down on the court and ended up getting that traveling call. That could have went either way as well.
And so Graves County the possession. Mustangs lead 15-11. As it is going to be on the right-hand side, Mathis. Now goes towards the opposite block, picks up his dribble, looks, hands it off now on the wing to Waller. As Waller into the lane, towards the free throw line, picks up his dribble, goes out to Vukasevic. Graves County with the possession, 4:15 in this second quarter. Vukasevic on the far right side and gives it out towards the top of the key to Pick. He's going to fire a contested three and bury it. Nice shot from the top of the key by Lucas Pick. Cuts the McCracken lead to one. It's 15-14. Connor Miller up the floor to Caden Fulcher. To Miller in the corner to Grogan. Straight out Fulcher, swung to Parrish. As Parrish has it taken away and stolen, and then it is knocked loose again. Great effort from the Mustangs as they're able to keep it in bounds. It goes now to Fulcher. As Fulcher, he thought about a three, goes to Miller. As Miller now to Clope at the foul line. Goes on the wing to Grogan. Straight away, Fulcher, a long three, no good. Rebound comes down to Graves County. Up the floor, it's Lucas Pick. As Pick out top to Mathis. Out now straight away to Vukasevic, swung on the left side to Pick. To Holland, now on the right-hand side, they swing it. Back at the foul line to Waller. Waller thought about a jump shot, goes into the corner. A three on the way from Vukasevic, too strong. Rebound comes down to Connor Miller. Mustangs bring it up, leading 15-14. Very much a half-court type game. Nobody's guarding Connor Miller. He'll take a three, no good, way off. Rebound comes down to Graves County, and it's going to be a timeout for Graves County. This is definitely the pace of play the Eagles want. But Mercy, it can be hard to watch. This crowd is quite quiet.
It is quiet in here. I mean, there's not a whole lot of excitement at this type of basketball. You got 2:42 left here in the second quarter, and you're at 15-14. So, you know, overall, Eric, you and I finished watching a pretty slow quarter, or excuse me, slow half in that second half of the Lady Mustangs game with only 17 points being put up in a half. Here we're looking at almost a half with only 29 points put up. So pretty slow basketball over the last four quarters that you and I have called. But like you said, Graves County likes that pace. I mean, right now, Eric, when you look at it, neither one of these teams may break 40 points tonight.
And so Graves County with the possession leading 15-14.
I like, Eric, the Mustangs defense. I talked a little bit about it at the break between the quarters. Talk a little bit about it again. The Mustangs have done a good job keeping that defensive pressure on Graves County out around the perimeter and not allowing them to get any shots off. I mean, there's been a number of times the Graves County player looks like they want to shoot a three-pointer, and the Mustang defenders just close quickly and don't allow them to get that shot.
And so Graves County, the possession, as it goes into Waller, and that is an offensive foul, as it will go back to McCracken County.
Yeah, Eric, and I think one of the things here for Graves County, I mean, I think that's Waller's first foul, but, you know, overall, he wouldn't be a guy that Graves County would want to lose here tonight, being 6'5". He's the big man in the middle for Graves County. He's scoring most of their points so far in this first half, so like to see Waller pick up some fouls. That'd be an advantage to the Mustangs.
It will be Martin into the front court as Martin turns, gives it out to Parrish. As Parrish throws it away, it is going to be a turnover back to Graves County. 2:12 left in this first half, 15-14. And Graves walks it into the front court. It will be Lucas Pig. As Pig dribbling out top. And Pig turns back to the sideline. Graves waits patiently. Pig gets a high screen. Pig goes now on the right-hand side. Gets it back. A minute 40 to Carrico. Now Carrico starts a dribbling exhibition on the left-hand side to Vukasevic. As he looks towards the entry to the post, as it goes to Carrico, back out to Vukasevic. Now swung on the right-hand side, Waller. He puts the dribble down into the lane, all the way to the opposite block. His layup up, no good. Rebound comes down to McCracken County. The Mustangs want to push it. As Clope into the front court. Nice pass underneath. The layup's gone. And there's a burst of excitement into this game.
Yeah, man, that was a nice drive down the court by Jackson Clope. He had that head of steam, but he did the right thing there. He found Connor Miller wide open on the other side of the paint for an easy basket at the rim.
It will be on the left-hand side as it goes to Vukasevic. As Vukasevic puts the dribble down and to the rim. He will be fouled in the process by Grogan. Just the team's second foul with 52 seconds left in this first half.
Eric, not a lot of fouls so far in this first half. I think I got to ask the question, is it the contribution of how slow the play
Mercy
is? You just don't get any fouls in this slow of play, and not a lot of fouls in these first two quarters.
As it goes on the left-hand side, to Holland. Back on top to Vukasevic. And with 48 seconds left, I think we're going to just sit here and watch as Holland holds the basketball. Mercy. Down to 35 seconds. On the left-hand side to Pick. Swung on the right-hand side to Holland. Out top to Pick. Down to 25 seconds. Down to 20 seconds. Down to 15 seconds. Down to 10. Straight away it goes to Carrico. And now to Vukasevic. He goes into the lane, puts one up, and gets it to go. A nice sequence there. And that will do it for what was quite the slow first half. After one half of play, the Mustangs lead the Eagles 17-16. And that is the halftime score. When we come back, we will mention the halftime scoring and the Estes Chiropractic second half adjustments when we return. 99.5 The Fan.
We understand that life happens, and sometimes you need a little financial boost. That's why at C-Plant Federal Credit Union, we offer low-rate loans tailored to your needs. Whether it's a car loan, a personal loan, or anything in between, we've got you covered. Learn more at cplant.com or visit any of C-Plant Federal Credit Union's 9 local branches. Member NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
When it comes to opening a new bank account, I have very high opening requirements. Amazingly, F&B Bank's Your Start Bundle Checking Plus Savings pulls out all the stops. A 2.25% APY on your first $15,000, free nationwide ATMs, a great mobile app, and more. Hey, when you meet a bank that complies with your terms, it's not about small print. It's your big goals and dreams. Get your start at F&B. APY is annual percentage yield. Standard rate of 0.20% APY will apply to balances over $15,000. See bank for terms and conditions. F&B Bank, member FDIC.
Are you looking for a bargain after the holiday season? McDonald's has it for you. For a limited time, buy a Big Mac, a quarter pounder with cheese, a 10-piece chicken McNugget, or a fillet of fish, and get another one for just $1. And don't forget, the best way to start your day is at McDonald's for their everyday breakfast deal. Buy a sausage biscuit, a sausage McMuffin, or a sausage McGriddle, and get another one for just $1. You can find it all at McDonald's. I'm loving it, aren't you?
Just like your fingerprint, your heartbeat is unique to you. And that's how your heart care should be too. So at Baptist Health, we focus on your specific cardiac needs, from preventive care to some of the most advanced procedures. For your one-of-a-kind heart, choose the one hospital system more people trust for their heart care. Baptist Health. It's care centered on you. Visit baptisthealth.com/heartcare.
At CFSB, we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors and friends. But what truly sets us apart is our commitment to community. Join us in supporting local initiatives, from schools to charities, and celebrating what makes our home special, because together we help our community thrive. Experience banking with a heart, where your needs are heard and your community's growth is our priority. Visit us online at yourlifecarebank.com. CFSB, member FDIC.
Discover the difference that comes from a financial partner committed to building better tomorrows. I'm Darren Rudolph with Baird Private Wealth Management in Paducah. As a provider of trusted financial services in Paducah, Baird is committed to making the future brighter for you and for our community. That's why we support local organizations like United Way and West Kentucky Fellowship of Christian Athletes, because we care about Paducah. Discover the Baird difference. Visit paducah.bairdwealth.com.
Hey guys, what do you want to do for dinner?
I want pizza.
Well, I want a salad.
I'm in the mood for some pasta.
I want ice cream.
Sounds like we're going to Pizza Inn.
Yay!
Pizza Inn is home to the area's largest buffet and salad bar. They also offer options for pickup, delivery, DoorDash, and even catering. Pizza Inn, where everybody wins. Locally owned since 1972. Located at 1001 Joe Clifton Drive in Paducah.
We understand that life happens, and sometimes you need a little financial boost. That's why at C-Plant Federal Credit Union, we offer low-rate loans tailored to your needs. Whether it's a car loan, a personal loan, or anything in between, we've got you covered. Learn more at cplant.com or visit any of C-Plant Federal Credit Union's 9 local branches. Member NCUA, Equal Housing Lender.
If you've ever had a pinched nerve, you know how excruciating the pain can be. I'm Bill Hughes, and when my pinched nerve sent pain shooting down my arm or down my sciatic nerve into my leg, I turned to the Back Brothers at Estes Chiropractic. The Back Brothers alleviated my pain, treated my problem, and got me back on the running trail. When you need relief, you can rely on the Back Brothers, Estes Chiropractic.
Doctors Kelly and Kevin Estes, the Back Brothers. Estes Chiropractic Center in Paducah. EstesChiropracticCenter.com.
One of the more lower scoring first halves call in for sure recent memory, and
It goes well back as it's a 17-16 first half in favor of McCracken County. As we welcome you back to the Bears broadcast booth alongside Jimmy Garrett, I'm Eric Chumbler. Thanks for joining us tonight. Let's take a look at all of that first half scoring. And with that, Jimmy Garrett.
So we'll take a look at Graves County first. Bukasevic, he had two in that first half. Lucas Pig, he had three. Mathis, he had three. And then Braden Waller, as I mentioned, he had 8 points, so half of the scoring so far coming tonight from Braden Waller. Taking a look at the Mustangs tonight, Connor Miller, he leads the team with 7 points. Jay Martin, he's got three off that three-pointer in the first quarter. Jackson Clope, only 2 points tonight, but boy, was it an exciting 2 points on that steal and slam dunk that Jackson Clope had there at the beginning of the game. Caden Fulcher, he's come in the game. He's got 2 points so far off the bench. And Grayson Parrish so far has 3 points, one at the free throw line, and then he had that 1 2-pointer right at the rim. One of the things is, Eric, I got to point out about this scoring. I had one of the fans here behind us ask me a question and pointed out something, that the Mustangs tonight in the first half have 17 points. And as you and I witnessed, Claire Johnson had 20 points by herself in the first half.
That is
in the first game. So Claire single-handedly outscored the Mustangs by herself in that first game.
Actually, if you want to put it, and the four teams competing tonight, obviously take out the Lady Mustangs, she outscored the Lady Eagles almost in the entire game, but for sure that first half, and she outscored both of these teams in that first half.
She did.
It's just Graves County basketball. They are going to slow it down to an entirely different level, and that's what they've done tonight. Let's take a look at the Estes Chiropractic second half adjustments. We need that adjustment. Go see the Back Brothers, Kevin and Kelly Estes of Estes Chiropractic, Central Avenue in Paducah. And if it's going to be this pace of game, continue that strong half-court defense.
So I think one of the things is, Eric, I was really pleased with the Mustangs. We talked about that perimeter half-court defense overall for the Mustangs, and they did a great job tonight. They really did a good job not allowing any of these really good shooters to get a lot of opportunities outside the perimeter. And I think, Eric, that's what's kept them in the lead and really kept this score down low for Graves County. So I think in the second half, they got to continue to do the same thing. They got to continue to put pressure on these Graves County shooters out on the perimeter. That's why really you saw them push the ball inside the wall, or that's where 8 of their 16 points have come from so far. So good perimeter defense from the Mustangs. I think they've got to continue that in the second half.
Also, former McCracken County, find a way to pick up the pace to the style of play that you like.
Yeah, I think, Eric, that's key. For the Mustangs to be successful, they've been fast all year long. It's been a quick-paced offense. I think they've got to continue to be able to do that in the second half to keep the lead overall against Graves County. So it'll be interesting to see in this third quarter, does the Mustangs come out and continue to play a slow-paced half-court offense, kind of matching up to what Graves County is doing, or does Coach Roberts have these guys put in some plays to really pick up the pace so overall the Mustangs are much quicker offensively than Graves County? I think that'll be the difference in the game.
That is your Estes Chiropractic second half adjustments. When you need that back adjustment, go see the Back Brothers, Kevin and Kelly Estes of Estes Chiropractic, Central Avenue in Paducah. It is a 17-16 halftime lead for the Mustangs. As the Mustangs looking like definitely the style of play that the Eagles won, but having to overcome that in the second half, still get the home win here tonight against the Eagles. As the crowd on hand, still a nice crowd here tonight. And a great crowd from McCracken County. Not as big as we normally see from Graves County when they come out to McCracken County, but not bad either. As McCracken County, just a wonderful crowd once again, and has been nearly all season long. It will be Graves County starting with the possession in the second half. Before they do, I want to remind you, tomorrow afternoon, doubleheader here on 99.5 The Fan. It will not be on YouTube tomorrow, just an FYI, as the girls play Delta Missouri at 2:30. And at 4 o'clock, the boys play Christian County. Both of those games here at Strawberry Hills Pharmacy Arena. Make a nice Saturday afternoon out to Strawberry Hills Pharmacy Arena and enjoy some basketball between McCracken County and Delta Missouri at 2:30.
And that is a group in Delta, Missouri, we're told, loves to press up and down the floor any chance they can. It will be an opposite of what you're seeing tonight. Same with the Lady Mustangs, and then two teams that love to run as well in the second game, McCracken County and Christian County. So what you're not seeing tonight, if you love basketball that's up and down, you'll see it tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah, it sounds like it. You know, I talked there a little bit with Coach Sibbles in between the games, and that's one of his concerns is Delta is really going to press the ball up and down the court. So, you know, we see the Lady Mustangs do it. And Eric, it'll be interesting to see a team that plays like kind basketball and how that plays out tomorrow afternoon.
So Graves County will start with the possession. As we start this second half, the Mustangs start with a one-point lead. It is 17-16, as it is going to be Vukasevic out top to Lucas Pig. As Pig, crossover dribble, gets by his defender, and his running jump shot no good. Tipped around, controlled by Grayson Parrish as he gives it off to Connor Miller. And the Mustangs start with the first possession of the second half for them. As it goes to Fulcher, back to Martin. Down low to Clope. He turns on the baseline, gives it off now to Parrish as Grayson turns in the lane, spins, short jump shot is short. Rebound fought for, controlled by Clope. Jackson goes up strong, puts it up no good. Rebound Parrish puts it up no good. Rebound's loose on the floor, and it's going to be a tied possession. That will go with McCracken County.
Eric, I said the Mustangs would have an advantage rebound. They got three rebounds on that one series right there, two by Grayson Parrish and one by Jackson. Clope, you talk about pushing up your rebound, the numbers. That was three offensive rebounds there in just a matter of seconds.
It will be McCracken County to inbound it. As it goes to Parrish, now to Martin. Now straight away to Fulcher. His floating jumper's blocked. Rebound tipped around, out of bounds off the Mustangs, over to Graves County. Mustangs back defensively. Graves County a one-point lead, 17-16. Eagles walking up as it's going to be Reagan Mathis. He goes on the left-hand side to Lucas Pig. As Pig goes off of a high screen, now works towards the low block. Floater off the glass is good. As Lucas Pig with his fifth point, it is now 18-17. Jay Martin in the backcourt. He loses it for a moment. It goes to Fulcher, though. The Mustangs got to get it up. They do to Clope. As Clope all the way to the rim, takes contact, no good. Rebound comes back to Graves County. It will be the Eagles into the front court as Pig, as he got tripped up and he's fouled. As that was, I believe, called on Martin, as I think Jay may have twisted his ankle and trying to work it off, but he is in a little bit of pain and wants to get checked out. So it will be Grogan coming in for Martin. Hopefully Jay is all right and just slightly twisted it. And he's putting more and more pressure on it with the more he walks. And actually he's not going to go see trainer Aaron. Hey, he might now, as a layup up by Waller is good. Mustangs trail 20-17, 6:22 in this third quarter. As Miller up to Grogan. Now straight away to Fulcher. Thought about a three, puts the dribble down, spins, gives it out to Miller. Miller goes off of the screen, gives it off left side. A three from Grogan is no good. Rebound comes out long, and it's out of bounds off Parrish. It will go to Graves County. 20-17, 6 minutes in this third quarter.
Eric, this looks similar to last third quarter we watched.
That's
a little,
right.
A little bit of sloppy play here in these first 2 minutes, very much so similar to what we saw in the girls' game.
Reagan Mathis goes on the right-hand side to Vukasevic at the foul line to Pig. As he goes up strong, no good. Rebound comes down to Miller. Connor will return it for the Mustangs. As Miller, top of the key. Goes off of a screen, takes some contact, and he missed it, but he'll get two free throws.
Yeah, that was a nice, we know Connor Miller, man, once he gets going there right at the top of the key, he'll drive it all the way to the rim, and there he went right around. It looked like the Pig pick up that foul there. He drove right through him to the rim. Pig was moving right with him, so that was an easy call for the official.
So two free throws coming for Connor Miller. As his first free throw's good. One more free throw coming for Connor Miller. His second free throw on the way, and it's good. 20-19, 5:41 in this third quarter. Graves County a one-point lead. as Mathis and Vukasevic in the backcourt. Vukasevic crosses the timeline to Mathis. Back to Vukasevic. Now on the left-hand side, goes cross-court to Carrico. Into the paint now to Mathis. Turns, gives it back out. Carrico to Vukasevic. As he is going to be poked and fouled. It's going to be on Connor Miller, I believe.
I think that'll be his second foul so far tonight. So one of the good things is, Eric, we don't have any Mustangs in foul trouble coming into this third quarter.
As it is, Graves County with the possession. As Mathis goes to Carrico. To Mathis. Off of a screen. Gives it out top to Vukasevic. Swung to Carrico. 20-19. Graves by one here in this third quarter. As Pig down on the block to Waller. He turns against Miller. Gives it back to Pig. Back to Waller. Back to Pig. Back to Waller. As he works now towards the low block. And he turns. His 5-foot jump shot. It's good. Nice shot there by Braden Waller. He's got 12. Leads all scorers tonight. That makes it 22-19. And a basketball made its way onto the floor and launched back into the student section. As it will be, McCracken to inbound it, sideline out of bounds. Quiet atmosphere here tonight. Big crowd, but just a lifeless action right now, and the fans quiet as a result, as it is going to be Fulcher, and he's fouled. As Vukasevic a little over-aggressive on the pursuit, commits the foul. That is his first, team second. As Fulcher will inbound it. Into the backcourt it goes to Grogan. Up the floor to Fulcher. And 4:12 left in this third quarter. Graves County on top, 22-19. Straight away to Clope. As he hands it off to Miller, he'll stop. Long three, no good. Rebound comes down to Waller. And Graves County will bring it the other way. As Vukasevic crosses it over. Turns into the lane, stops. His floater short, but he's fouled. That's going to be on Grogan. And Vukasevic will shoot two.
Yeah, Eric, this right here, this is an opportunity for Graves County to extend this lead to five. I think one of the things that's concerning, you don't want to get behind on Graves County. With this patient style play, you're not going to get a lot of opportunities to cut into the lead. So it's critical here for the Mustangs on this next offensive possession not to let this lead get any greater than 5 points.
As the first free throw was good, checking in for Graves County is Case Tubbs. Checking out is Braden Waller. So Graves County going a bit smaller now, trading out 6'5 to the bench for 6 foot as the free throw is good. Makes it 24-19, I believe. Or is it 23?
No, it's 24. You're
okay,
correct.
Okay, yeah, just a little late putting it on the scoreboard as it goes on the right side to Fulcher. Now straight away to Miller. As Miller crosses it over and gives it off into the corner to Clope. He stops. His floater's good. Jackson Clope on the baseline. He's got four. 24-21, 3:28 in this third quarter. Lucas Pick dribbling idly. Mercy. Lucas still putting on a fine dribbling exhibition. Goes on the left side of Vukasevic. Now to Carrico. His three is no good. Rebound comes down to Connor Miller. He'll bring it the other way as Miller, top of the key, goes right side to Parrish. In the corner, Grogan, his three on the way. It's no good. Rebound back to Graves County as it comes into the front court. Lucas Pig, as he stops, turns, gives it out to Vukasevic. As Vukasevic goes on the left-hand side. And it's picked off and stolen by Grogan. All the way to the rim, puts it up, and in, and he's fouled. And a burst of energy from the crowd. As the Mustangs get their offense going the way they want it, as Grogan the end one.
That was a nice steal. You know, Eric, we commented the other night against St. Mary's. Owen Grogan went off there, scored 7 straight points along with Connor Miller to cut that 10-point lead down to one there midway through the third quarter. Right now, the Mustangs needed something to get some energy in this team. We got to give Owen Grogan credit. He stole that ball, was able to pick it up, drive it to the rim, and pick it, put it in. And this three-point conversion right here will tie the game back up. Good job, Owen Grogan, on that last play.
As the free throw from Grogan is good, the Mustangs tied up at 24, 2:35 in this third quarter. I was about to say I was a bit shocked that they took Waller out of the game. And the moment he did, McCracken went on a quick 5-0 run. And so Graves County brings Waller back into the game. 24-24, 2:30 in this third quarter. As it goes on the right side to Hollins. Out top to Vukasevic, swung towards Carrico. On the right-hand side towards Vukasevic. Back out top to Pig. Swung on the wing to Vukasevic. As he puts the dribble down, working against Grogan, all the way to the rim, reverse layup, blocked by Clope. The Mustangs get it. The Mustangs rush it the other way. Fulcher stops, turns, gives it to Martin. Thought about the three, puts the dribble down, back to Fulcher. He will take a long two and bury it. The Mustangs getting the action to go quicker and now take the lead by two. 26-24, that's a bit more exciting action. It will be with it. Lucas Pig, as Pig, top of the key, puts the dribble down, goes into the corner, back out to Pig. He will reset it for Graves County. As Pig, top of the key, spins, met by a double team, turns, his floater is good. Nice move there by Lucas Pig, the 5'11 senior. He's got seven, ties it at 26. A minute 15 in this third quarter. As Martin sets it up, 2-3 zone, change up for Graves County. Mustangs figure out what they want, goes to Fulcher. As Fulcher gets his defender in the air, attacks, his floater in the lane is good. Nice job by Caden Fulcher. Back-to-back baskets, 28-26, 50 seconds left in the third. Up and down we went for a little bit. As it is Pig. Goes off of a high screen, stops, goes into the corner. Wide open is Carrico. His three, it's no good. Rebound comes down to Grogan, gives it off to Martin. Jay on the left-hand side. As Jay goes straight away to Grogan, swings it right side to Fulcher. Now the Mustangs say, let's wait for the last shot with 30 seconds left as Jay Martin out top. Down to 20 seconds as it goes to Fulcher. Down to 15. Down to 10, and a bit of an aggressive foul there in terms of how far away from the basket, just in front of half court by Holland. It's the fourth team foul. It shouldn't hurt the Eagles unless they foul one more time in the last 11 seconds, and the Mustangs go to the foul line. It will be Fulcher to inbound it to Jay Martin with 10 seconds left. Martin into the front court. Goes on the wing to Miller. As Miller lost it for a moment, gets it back, lost it again, and that's going to do it. Actually, a foul called is, I don't know. Actually, it went out of bounds. I'm sorry. I couldn't tell what the official was calling. Well, now they're going to conference, and it is out of bounds against McCracken County to Graves County with 0.6 seconds here in this third quarter. Graves County to inbound it. As a three near the buzzer, no good, and that will do it for the third quarter. You saw a burst of offense there towards the end of the third quarter. The Mustangs were able to close it on a 8-2 run to take a two-point lead, 28-26. And, Jimmy, that's the kind of action the Mustangs wanted, more up-and-down action that allowed the Mustangs down five at one point to end the quarter up two.
Yeah, Eric, and you said it very well there earlier. It's really the pace of the game that was different. The Mustangs really stepped up the pace there in that last three or four minutes of this third quarter. One of the other things I think that you mentioned that was key as well is they took Waller out of the game there. They got up by 5 points. As soon as they got up by 5 points, they took Waller out of the game, put him on the bench, and the Mustangs just instantaneously came back and closed that five-point lead up and tied that game up and then ultimately took the lead. So, you know, one of the things is, Eric, that's interesting, Waller right now, I think he's only got one foul, but right now you got to say how Waller goes is how this team has went so far tonight. Give a little credit to Lucas Pig. He has made a few good baskets inside for Graves County here in the third quarter. But Eric, I'm going to make a little prediction here. I think the first team to 40 might win this game.
You may be right. Not many games you're going to see the Mustangs stay in the 40s at all. As the Mustangs, several games in the 90s, 80s, 70s. But tonight won't be one of those.
No, this game, like I said, Eric, right now, so you got three quarters in, you're averaging about 9 points a quarter per team. So, you know, to get to 40, one of these two teams are going to have to score 12 or 14 points. So I think that's going to be a stretch for what we've seen so far.
And so it is the start of the fourth quarter. The Mustangs a two-point lead. Want to give a shout-out to Jenna Roberts, Anna Roberts, and Ty Roberts listening in tonight. Good to hear from you all. Also, Steve Frick and Jane Ann Heath listening as well. Also, Go Mustangs from Mimi and Posh for Dylan Jackson in Naples, Florida. Good to hear from you all as well. We start this fourth quarter. Graves County starts with the basketball. Two-point lead for the Mustangs as it goes into Waller. His nice left-hand hook is perfect. Great start for Braden Waller. He's got 14. Tied at 28 as Jay Martin into the front court, and he takes a foul as that was on Mathis. And so his second foul, team's first.
You know, Eric, that became critical in that St. Mary's game, so it'll be interesting to see if one of these teams get to five fouls quickly. Right now, Graves County's got one, so they're off to a start here. That can be an advantage if you hit that five mark for the other team.
That's right. Connor Miller for the Mustangs. As it goes straight away to Cloak, 17-footer, no good. Rebound comes back to Graves County. Bit of a force shot, but Cloak gets it back and puts it up and in, and he's fouled.
Eric, I don't know how to quite call that play. I mean, Graves County come down with that rebound. Jackson Cloak just ran up there, yanked it out of his hands. I think Graves County wanted a tied-up ball. It really didn't look that way, and then Cloak took a step around him and just laid it on the glass. So it's interesting. It looked like they had a discussion on it.
And so they are going to discuss it. And it is, as we await, oh, mercy, that's the worst thing that can happen. They say an inadvertent whistle, so the Mustangs actually made the basket, but the inadvertent whistle means that the Mustangs will not get the basket. They won't get the and one. That's a bummer from McCracken County. And so a rare inadvertent whistle. And mercy, that's bad situation all around. Now Graves County's upset. Both benches right now very upset with the officiating.
You know, one thing is, Eric, it's not critical here. Even if Graves County wins the argument that it was a tied-up ball, it's McCracken County's ball still. The error is in McCracken County's favor.
Right.
So either way, how this call turns out, it's McCracken County's ball.
So Fulcher will inbound it. As Fulcher looking. And a foul down low. That's already two team fouls for Graves County in the first 35 seconds. Is that's going to be on Waller. And so we saw it Tuesday night how much getting to five fouls in the fourth quarter can make a big difference. Something to watch as Fulcher to inbound it to Miller. He pump fakes, turns, gives it off to Cloak. Cloak comes up strong, missed the layup. Rebound comes back to Graves County. Eagles on the return. It will be Lucas Pink who hands it off to Mathis. Back to Pink. Tied at 28, 7-10 in this fourth quarter. Have a shout out to get to in just a moment. Vukasevic. It's the dribble to Mathis. As Mathis spins, turns, back out to Pink. He stops, little up and under. Move is perfect. Nice move by Lucas Pink. He's got nine. Eagles back on top, 30-28. It'll be Jay Martin into the front court for McCracken County. Goes on the left side to Grogan, now in the corner. Back out to Martin. Swung on the right side to Fulcher. Back to Martin. Back to Fulcher. Thought about the three. To Jay. To Fulcher. To Martin straight away. He will take that three. It's too strong. Rebound comes back to Graves County. Then poked away and stolen by the Mustangs. Grogan up the floor to Miller. Miller into the lane. Stripped. Comes back to Cloak, though. Over to Fulcher. Back out it comes to Jay Martin. And the Mustangs set up down by two. 6:15 left in the game. It will be Martin, top of the key. Goes to Cloak. Down low to Miller. His layup missed it. Back-to-back missed layups by Cloak and Miller. It comes back to Graves County. It will be top of the key to Waller. Right side to Mathis. Mathis cross-court now to Vukasevic. And Graves County going to slow it down and spread it out. as they have four across the baseline. Now start their half-court offense. It's a nice crossover by Vukasevic, and he's going to draw the foul from Grogan. Want to give a shout-out to one of the best Mustangs to put on the jersey. Jackson Sybil's listening in. Also, Morgan Thompson, good to hear as well. And teammate of Jackson's at Wofford from Canada, Kyler Fowlich, excuse me, checking in on the Mustangs. Good to hear from you all. Is a 30-second timeout on the floor. Mustangs trail by two, 30-28. And a really nice job by Lucas Pick on that last half-court sequence from the Eagles. A very nice up-and-under layup by Pick.
You know, Eric, that's the third time we've seen Lucas Pick do that here in the second half. He's really done a good job getting into the lane there and just squeezing by his defender and getting it up on the glass and getting it in. That'll be crucial for the Mustangs to get stopped here in the last 5 minutes and 44 seconds. So I think the situation here for the Mustangs, they've got to get a stop here. Like I said, I think with this slow style play that Graves County likes to play, if you got down 5 or 7 points this late in the fourth quarter, I can see them just holding that till you foul them and put them on the free throw line. So I think a stop here and go back down and make a basket, gets this game tied back up, is critical for the Mustangs over this next possession.
30-28, the Mustangs trail by two. It's a three from Pig, no good. Rebound comes along to Jay Martin. As Jay into the front court, he loses it. Taken back by the Eagles and taken back by Fulcher. Fulcher in the corner to Miller. He turns into the lane and he's fouled, and there's three fouls for Graves County. At just 2.5 minutes into this one. It will be the Mustangs basketball underneath their own baskets.
Yeah, Eric, that was a critical call there. I almost thought it was good they called that foul before Connor Miller took another step. I almost thought they were going to get him for traveling. And fortunately, it was a foul. And like you said, right now, Graves County's in trouble with three fouls.
As it goes to Fulcher, and he just almost lost it out of bounds as Fulcher gives it up to Clope. And a timeout from Coach Roberts with 5:19 in this fourth quarter. It's a 30-second timeout. If you're just joining us, it has been a slow-paced Graves County-style basketball game. They've wanted it to be this way. And the Mustangs normally scoring 60, 70, 80 points a game. It's definitely Graves County's favor. It is a slow-paced game.
Yeah, it is, Eric. And unfortunately for the Mustangs, you know, right now we're down 2 points, but we missed three layups in a row here in the last 60 seconds or so. So unfortunate for the Mustangs. They could have tied this game up, could have had an opportunity to get the lead, which I think is critical right now. So I think for the Mustangs, coming out of this timeout right here that Coach Roberts called, they've got to execute well here, get a basket, get this game tied back up, and cause Graves County to play offense and not just sit on the ball like we've seen him throughout this game.
So the Mustangs trail by two with the basketball. 30-28, 5:19 left in regulation. It will be Fulcher to inbound it as Fulcher gets it inbounds to Jay Martin. And the Mustangs start with the possession as Vukasevic shading him to go to the left side, hands it off to Fulcher. Back out to Miller. As Miller gives it up to Martin. At the foul line to Parrish, now to Miller. His three for the lead, no good. Rebound comes down to Graves County as a nice job by Carrico to claim the board. Gives it off to Vukasevic with 4:55 left in the game. To Mathis. To Vukasevic, to Mathis. And now into the front court it goes to Pig. Into the lane, his layup is no good. Rebound out of bounds off the Eagles over to the Mustangs. And so McCracken County will get it, trailing 30-28. As it comes in to Jay Martin.
Eric, Mustangs got to score. This is their fifth opportunity here to tie this game up.
That's right. And then another unnecessary foul right in front of half court from the Eagles. They now have, from this point on, no more fouls to give. And that was not a good foul for Graves County at all.
It was not.
And so Mustangs shooting free throws the rest of the game. It will go to Connor Miller. As Miller into the lane, goes left side to Martin. Gets his man by him. His three for the lead is perfect. The freshman comes up big. The Mustangs have the lead, 31-30. 4:14 left in regulation. In the backcourt with it, it's Vukasevic. Now into the front court to Pig. Down low to Waller. He turns in the lane, and that's a blocking foul against Parrish. And as Waller went to the rim and was able to draw the contact from Parrish, And the Mustangs will have it underneath. Just a second team foul against McCracken County. As it will be Tatum Holland checking back in for Graves County. With Parrish going to the deck. A little bit of moisture on the floor they're going to clean up. Mustangs by one, 31-30. With 4:02 left in regulation. So the Eagles stand out underneath their own basket. As they go in to Vukasevic, he almost traveled with it, gives it out to Mathis. His three, no good. Rebound comes down to McCracken County. Jay Martin will walk it up for McCracken County with 3:50 left. Mustangs by one, goes straight away to Miller. Miller into the lane, nice spin move. His layup is perfect. Mustangs with five in a row, it's 33-30. Eagles can't afford to get down by much more with their style of play. Vukasevic, this is a big series for Graves County. Straight away it comes, that is to Holland, and it's taken away by the Mustangs. Miller crosses it over into the lane, and he's fouled, and that is the big deal we've been talking about this entire time. Graves County over-aggressive defensively, and already the Mustangs have got five fouls on the Eagles. They'll go to the foul line.
Yeah, Eric, you know, you talked about this Tuesday night. The Mustangs were in that same situation. They picked up five quick fouls against St. Mary's and nearly lost that game, given St. Mary's all those free throw shots. Tonight, Graves County's done it. Tonight, it's a benefit to the Mustangs.
As Miller's free throw is good, and these are accurate calls. It's just Graves County just being over-aggressive defensively. A couple of fouls near half court behind the three-point line. And now the Mustangs going to shoot because of it, and a chance to go up five. The second free throw is good.
You know, Eric, I got to ask Coach Roberts a question. Does he take, when the Mustangs get the ball, do they slow down offensively?
Now you might.
Really limit Graves County to maybe one, two, or three more possessions in this game and walk out of here with this victory below 40 points like I talked about just a few moments ago.
It's a 7-0 run for the Mustangs. It is going to be Mathis on the right-hand side using the dribble. Goes now down low, poked away, but it's going to be a foul on Parrish trying to go for the steal and made contact. It's the third team foul on McCracken County. Graves County will inbound it. Mustangs by five, 35-30. As it comes in on the right side, a three from Holland, no good. Rebound to Clope. He races the other way for the Mustangs. Clope into the lane, puts it up, and it's a blocking foul, and that will send Clope to the foul line to shoot two. The Mustangs have turned the tempo into their favor, and with that, currently on a 7-0 run and a chance to extend it.
Yeah, Eric, you know, the other night, Jackson Clope did a great job down the stretch at St. Mary's. He made two critical free throws in the last 18 seconds. Here, you've still got 2 minutes and 57 seconds left on the clock, but you're up by 5 points. It's critical for Clope to get one or two of these for certain.
As Clope's free throw is good, that makes it an 8-0 run for McCracken County. You see it time and time again, just how the Mustangs execute in the fourth quarter. Even with this extremely young ball club the Mustangs have, they about executed the Eagles in this fourth quarter once again, as the free throw from Clope is good. A 9-0 run for McCracken County in a matter of a couple of minutes. 2:50 left in the game. It is going to be Lucas Pig. Pig on the right side to Vukasevic. As Vukasevic turns into the lane, and he's going to be fouled by Fulcher. That will send Vukasevic to the foul line to shoot two. Very nice move there by Vukasevic. And a little bit more of an aggressive style of play there by the Eagles actually paid off, as they look to get in their offense quickly instead of stalling like they have been a good portion of the night. That paid off for the Eagles.
It did right here. It'll be interesting, Eric. You know, as much as they play this slowdown type of offense, it'll be interesting to see how they do when they've got to speed their game up.
As Vukasevic connects on the free throw, that cuts the McCracken lead to six. One more free throw for Vukasevic. His free throw is no good. Rebound comes down to the Mustangs. See if the Mustangs now try to slow it down and use some clock here as it goes to Jay Martin. No, they won't, as it goes to Miller for the layup.
Mustangs continuing to execute in this fourth quarter. It's an 11-1 run. 2:25 left in the game. The Mustangs up 8. On the left side, it goes to Vukasevic. A baseline drive. He stops. His running floater's no good. The Mustangs get it up to Fulcher. Fulcher in the corner. Miller's three. No good. Rebound back to Fulcher. The Mustangs will get it back in a timeout from Coach Roberts. And the Mustangs have put away a nice Graves County Eagles attempt tonight. They're up 8 with 2 minutes left.
Yeah, Eric, it's sad that the three-pointer right there by Connor Miller didn't drop. I'll be right there. That would have put him up, 11 points there if Connor's three-pointer would have shot. But we've got to go back to that play before that. You know, Caden Fulcher got that rebound. He got it across half court. He got it over to Jay Martin. And you could see from mine and your angle, I mean, Connor Miller was down there under the basket just swinging his arms, wanting somebody to see him wide open down there. I got to fault Graves County, Eric. They didn't do a good job getting back on defense after that missed free throw, and it gave Connor Miller an opportunity to get that easy basket at the rim. And when you looked over there at the coaching staff for Graves County, the head coach, he was really frustrated with his guys that after that rebound on that missed free throw, they didn't get back and allow the Mustangs to just expand the lead by another 2 points. So overall, you've got to give credit to the Mustangs, Eric. They've outplayed the Eagles in this fourth quarter.
So the Mustangs on top, 39-31 with 2:04 left. We talked about how big of a deal with style of play. You really don't want to get down more than 5. And you certainly cannot afford to give up an 11-1 run. And that is the situation currently facing the Eagles. Not necessarily over, but they've got to abandon their style of play to try and come back and win it here tonight. And so the Mustangs will inbound it underneath their own basket. It will be Fulcher to do it. As it goes into Martin. And Jay will bring it out. See if the Mustangs make the Eagles in now. As it goes to Fulcher. As Fulcher out to, oh, it's picked off by Pig. Lucas on the way to the rim. His right-hand layup, he missed it. Rebound comes down to the Mustangs. As Klope will bring it into the front court to Martin. Now to Fulcher with a minute 40 left. To Pig, right side to Parrish. Mustangs spread it out again. Out to Martin, to Fulcher. A minute 30 left. To Klope, down low to Parrish. His layup is good, and he's fouled.
Oh, Eric, Grayson Parrish has got to feel great about that. I got to say one thing just for the fans at home so you know. Grayson Parrish made a layup, but he was standing directly under the net. I didn't think he had any chance at all of getting that ball up around the rim and in. And I got to give Grayson Parrish credit. He pulled off something I just didn't think was possible.
That was a phenomenal finish for Grayson. His free throw is no good. 13-1 run for the Mustangs, leading 41-11. A minute 18 left in the game. Is a three straight away is no good. Rebound comes down to Klope. He gives it off to Martin. And Jay in the backcourt gives it up to Klope. He pushes it down the floor to Parrish. His layup, no good. Rebound Miller. And I was going to say, surely they call something on that.
Yeah, Eric, I got to say, I mean, for Grayson Parrish, that was a much better angle for a layup there than he had last time. Unfortunately, he missed the easier of the two shots here in the last 30 seconds.
To be fair, he did take minor abuse on that shot.
I think he was back on the back of his number on the back of his jersey when he hit the court. So for the fans listening at home, that's how hard he got hit.
That's right. As Parrish's free throw is good.
Eric, Grayson never makes a shot look easy.
That's right. But mercy, is he effective? He has been a wonderful senior for the Mustangs this year. His second free throw is no good. Rebound comes down to Graves County. The Mustangs on a 14-1 run to close this one out. As Pig into the lane, gets his defender in the air, puts it up no good, but he's fouled. Another nice win coming up for the Mustangs. And now they will close this one out and turn their attention to Christian County tomorrow and Carlisle County on Monday nights.
Eric, I have a feeling that'll be a much faster game tomorrow night.
Agreed.
Against Christian County.
That will be a fun one to watch as Pig puts down the first. Graves County bringing in Ty Cabot.
the 6'1 freshman.
Eric, he looks like he's got a potential to be a pretty good athlete.
He does. His father was a Graves County Eagle, played around my time as Pig makes them both. Was quite the athlete as well. As the Mustangs up 42-33, 14-3 run for McCracken County. Inbounds comes to Fulcher. As Fulcher to Martin. Back to Fulcher. And a timeout for Coach Dustin Roberts as they were running up against the 10-second clock. 30-second timeout. If you're McCracken County, you've got to feel good tonight. Graves County had their pace of play nearly the entire game before the Mustangs flipped that script in the fourth quarter. And, boy, did the Mustangs flip that script.
They did, Eric. I mean, they've had a great fourth quarter. I mean, overall, you got to say for three quarters, Graves County played their style of basketball, and the Mustangs really conceded to play that kind of basketball for three full quarters. But, you know, Coach Roberts continued to make adjustments. He made a good adjustment here in the fourth quarter. Finally, the Mustangs were able to pick up pace, and that's really the difference in the game. I mean, if you look at it, if the Mustangs played at that pace all night long, this easily could have been a 20-point win. But you got to give credit to Graves County. They did a nice job slowing this game down for three quarters.
And so it is going to be Martin in the backcourt, now in the front court to Miller, to Clope. He goes on the right side to Fulcher. As Fulcher into the lane, as he takes some contact, goes out to Parrish, and Parrish is fouled. With 37 seconds left.
Eric, I've got to ask a question. Grayson Parrish, if he can make a couple of these free throws, I'm thinking he might be in double digits tonight.
He lets me, he heads to the foul line, let me count that up. He is still a bit short. He has, if he makes this, he does. That is seven.
Okay.
For Grayson. And one more coming for Parrish. The second free throw, no good. Rebound comes down to Graves County. As a three coming straight away, no good. Rebound to Clope. As Clope will bring it into the front court to Fulcher. With 25 seconds left, Fulcher left side to Miller. As Miller is on the right-hand side, it's going to be a timeout from McCracken County. 18 seconds left. And again, going back to this one tonight, you played an entire game with your opponent's pace of play and were able to beat that opponent. That is, with such a young ball club from McCracken County that's only getting better and better each game, that's probably, morale standpoint, when you think about how you are against Graves County, probably the best possible scenario, because you've shown you can play their style of basketball and still find a way to come out on top.
Yeah, Eric, really, you got to give the Mustangs credit. This is two games in a row. I mean, we go back to that St. Mary's game where they were down 10 in the third quarter. This young team did a great job coming back and winning this game, or that game on Tuesday evening. They've come back and done it again tonight when they were down 5 points at one time. They came back and got the lead here and won again tonight. I think one thing, Eric, that I've got to point out that I really never thought about till just now is you got to give the Mustangs credit. One of the things I think that they've done in this second half that we've not mentioned so far, they took Waller out of the game.
That's right.
I mean, really, Waller's not done much contributing here in the second half. So overall, I've got to say, was that an adjustment that Coach Roberts made at halftime? And you got to admit, overall, Waller's been silent this entire quarter.
And so the Mustangs will inbound it with 18 seconds left, up by 10. And so Fulcher will do the honors for McCracken County. And get it into the backcourt to, well, almost nobody, as Jay Martin had to rush it down. And he gets it off, and Jay's going to be fouled. So that'll send Jay to the foul line to shoot two.
So, Eric, one of the things I got to comment on, I was laughing about there at halftime. I said the first team to 40 would win. Well, the Mustangs got 43, and
you,
they're
going
to walk out of here with a victory tonight.
Indeed.
I think that's the difference in the game. You had to get 40 points on the board to win this ball game, and the Mustangs were able to.
I want to give a shout-out to good friend Jake Simmons. Makes a great point when you talk about the Mustangs flipping the script. Is Jay's free throw no good? The three-quarter court pressure by McCracken County, thank you to Jake for this, really helped the Mustangs change Graves County out of their style of play and allow the Mustangs to go on that 14-1 run.
Yeah, anytime you can get a good press defense going, you can be successful. We see that out of the girls' basketball team all the time. And granted, he's correct. The Mustangs did it here this evening.
44-33. As the Mustangs, 15 seconds left away from a win. As Vukasevic into the lane, his floating layup is good. Makes it a 44-35 game. As it's knocked out of bounds, that'll do it. The Mustangs win it again tonight. Final score, 44-35. McCracken County moves to 16-5. Graves County drops to 15-6. Overall, it was a slow game here this afternoon, but the Mustangs able to speed it up in the fourth, Jimmy, and come away with a near double-digit win.
Yeah, Eric, we got to talk about slow basketball. I'm going to go back to the girls' game. We saw two slow quarters there in the third and fourth quarter, and then we saw three more here tonight. So for you and I calling this game and for the fans here, like you said, it was really a full house here at Strawberry Hill Arena tonight. Saw seven quarters of really fairly slow basketball. Excuse me, five quarters overall, some fairly slow basketball. Finally, the Mustangs were able to pick it up in the fourth quarter, and that was the big difference. Mustangs did a great job. I think another thing is they were able to finally start executing. You know, there for a while that Graves County had a two-point lead. The Mustangs missed three layups in a row, but once they got converted, they did a great job overall taking the lead and just maintaining that lead. And I think that was critical, too. You know, one of the things is that we talked a little bit about halftime there off the air was if you got behind Graves County somewhere late in the fourth quarter, you could see Graves County just try to hold their offense, keep the ball, and not give you any offensive opportunities. But fortunately for the Mustangs, midway through that fourth quarter, they got the lead, just was able to hold it throughout the remainder of this game and really caused Graves County to get out of their style of offense. We saw them try to execute here. We saw Pig driving a little bit inside. He was successful. McCracken County, one of the things is, Eric, that I want to talk about just for a moment is how good a perimeter defense the Mustangs did tonight. They did not allow Graves County many open threes. I mean, I think that was one of the differences in this game. When you look at the stats for Graves County, they want to get a lot of points outside the perimeter. We talked about that in the pregame as one of the things for the keys to success, and I think the Mustangs executed it very well tonight as they didn't allow Graves County to get a lot of three-pointers. I think that'll be another key on some other games that we may see later in the year, particularly if we come back up against Callaway County again.
That's right. And so the Mustangs win it tonight. Final score, 44-35. The Mustangs winners over Graves County. Let's take a look at the final scoring for tonight. And once again with that, Jimmy Garrett.
So let's take a look at Graves County first. Briley Bukasic, he had a total of seven tonight. Then you take a